Welcome, everyone, to WCW Worldwide Wrestling. Tony Schiavone and the living legend, Larry Zbysko. Well, we are into the month of August in 1998, and that means that Road Wild is just around the corner. We'll be talking a lot about that, but right now, our opening bout is going to have a young man from Japan who making his debut, Saito, here on WCW Worldwide, living legend.
In a famous name this man is carrying, although there's no relation, Masa Saito was a terror along the Far East. I wrestled the man for the world championship in the first Tokyo Dome ever in front of 70,000 people. And this man carries a very big name, same name, and we'll see if he has the same ability. Masa Saito wrestled for the Olympics for Japan years ago. There's one big pair of shoes to fill for a young Japanese kid with the same name.
Fans, during the course of this program, as you see the appearance of the Ultimo Dragon, during the course of this program, we are going to show you what went down recently on an edition of WCW Monday Nitro, where NWO Hollywood took charge, won the World Tag Team Championship, the Giant and Scott Hall did, won the U.S. Heavyweight title, Bret the Hitman Hart did, on a night, and also show you how Buff Bagwell pulled a fast one over everyone, including Rick Steiner. It was a night
for
NWO Hollywood to really shine, living legend.
Well, again, the NWO is stooping to no lows. I mean, even Bagwell, I'd like to slap him. I even felt sorry for the kid. I mean, he got me, and that's not easy.
You're not kidding, that's not easy. Go behind here by Ultimo Dragon for a chancery, and Saito comes away with that one into a full-arm dragon twist. We're not making light of the injury to Buff Bagwell, which was legit, it was serious, but Bagwell has bounced back from it even better than we originally thought.
Well, it was a very serious injury. I mean, he was almost paralyzed, and the fact that he would use an injury of that nature to fool Rick Steiner and the entire world shows that the NWO is thinking, but they are thinking low, and they will take every shortcut in the book. They will stab anybody in the back.
Yeah, there's nothing too low for NWO Hollywood. The black and the white jump to hook, walking over the top, top of the head, watch out, cross body into the shoulder, handspring, and it caught him with a back elbow out of a handspring.
Got him, Ultimo Dragon has got, oh, he put the brakes on. Thought he was almost going to get him a clothesline.
But he did not get him a clothesline.
I know he didn't.
Down on the floor, Saito trying to think one step ahead of Ultimo Dragon.
Well, that is a hard thing to do. Ultimo Dragon, experienced. Oh, he telegraphed that one.
Ducked his head, using the hood, using that mask, and pulling the man back down to the mat. Look at Saito here with a vengeance.
Well, he better have a vengeance. Ultimo Dragon, tough man to beat. He's got him on the mat. That takes away the movement. Don't stand there, kid. You'll never live up to a famous name.
Scoop slam. Saito now. Up. Springboard. Missile drop kick and a great move. One.
Two and a half. Ultimo Dragon just squirmed out of that one.
He'll send the dragon in. Deep arm drag takedown. Into a cross arm breaker.
Yeah, he's got that nice execution. It should be a little higher up on that elbow with it. He's too close to the wrist, actually.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, next Saturday, what a night it's going to be. What a day it's going to be in Sturgis, South Dakota for WCW at Road Wild, including a concert from Travis Tritt, all in the same night. And it's available only on pay-per-view. We'll be talking about it during the course of this program. Back chop by Ultimo Dragon, front chop. Knee lifts here, repeated.
Oh, right in the mush!
And then a spin kick to put the man down. Ultimo Dragon picks him up.
Oh!
Brainbuster dropped him down. Oh, my!
One for good measure.
And now, the Dragon Sleeper. That means this match is over.
Yeah, it's not looking good for Saito.
The Ultimo Dragon with the dreaded Dragon Sleeper in the opening round. Fundamentally sound, mechanically as sound as you'll ever find.
what he said.
Whatever it was, it's a 1-800 collect replay.
But I guess Saeed, a little young and inexperienced, not nothing like the Master Masa was, but I think that was the shot. That was just clean on the chinny chin chin, and the Dragon hooked him for the winny win win.
1-800-COLLECT is the way we call collect today. We take you now to Stagger Lee Marshall with his interview on Worldwide.
It is the Summer Classic coming up. Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall with Word About Road Wild, that huge motorcycle rally and race coming from Sturgis, South Dakota, August 8th. And not only that, but we are going to have our third annual Road Wild. Travis Tritt's going to be there performing, by the way. For you to take part in Road Wild number 3, all you've got to do is get on your American-made machine and make a beeline for the Black Hills of South Dakota. Now, if that doesn't work into your plans, not a problem, then call your cable operator right now. Tell them you want to be part of Road Wild on pay-per-view. Satellite dish owners, contact Turner Premier. It's on the Dish Network. And, of course, Direct Ticket with DirecTV. I want to now talk to a man that, well, quite honestly, he's got a bit of a cloud hovering over his head. Now, I've asked him to join me and maybe clear up a few things. And that has to do, Stevie Ray, with the World Television Championship. We saw you come out with a note that some people say was not written by Booker T. That, in
the
fact,
note
you,
was
that,
written by
that,
my brother.
Okay, but that maybe...
He gave it to me. I gave it to WCW officials. They had a problem with it. That's okay. We're getting the right documents drawn up. And this matter will be quickly solved in due time. So don't worry about it, brother.
All right. So then, in fact, we can expect a real document from a real lawyer, not something written in longhand with a crayon on the back of a Dairy Queen napkin.
Don't try to be funny, Lee Marshall.
Oh, I wasn't trying to be funny.
You don't know me that well.
Well, I know that, quite honestly, up until this point, I've never had reason to question whether or not what you were saying was accurate.
It's very accurate. And as soon as those papers are drawn up, as soon as they're presented to that quack J.J. Dillon, then I will be truly the world's television champion, and I will be carrying on my family legacy like I do so well.
All right, thank you very much, Booker T., the man that his own brother calls Big Brother. Whether or not, well, we'll wait to see whether that documentation will be forthcoming. We can only hope. Fans, once again, we remind you, get Road Wild on pay-per-view.
All right, fans, back on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. Our feature bout still to come later on. A Lucha Libre tag team match still to come within this hour. But living legend Larry Zbyszko, next Saturday, Road Wild from Sturgis, South Dakota. The third straight year we've been a part of the Great Sturgis Rally. But as we head to next Saturday, Hollywood Hogan, more vicious than ever, obviously since losing the world title to Goldberg a few weeks back.
You know, more vicious than ever, more embarrassed, more humiliated than ever. You know, Goldberg and everybody in WCW and in the Red and Black New World Order take wear because more desperate men will use more desperate men.
He's been even questioning members of his own black and white NW Hollywood. Let's go back to the ring this week on Worldwide Wrestling.
Introducing first, accompanied to the ring by Raven's Flock, from parts unknown, Sid Boy!
I tell you, Tony, they know where this guy's from. Nobody wants to admit it.
Do you blame him?
Probably close to Rockford, Illinois.
Or Peoria.
Somewhere in there.
Thumbs down to the fans as Sick Boy with Raven and other members of the Flock makes his way to the ring. The Flock, they're just like that. They are sick. And he exemplifies everything bad about the Flock. Let's send you back to David Pinzer for the introduction of the opponent.
His opponent from San Juan, Puerto Rico, Julio Sanchez.
Julio Sanchez and Sick Boy. One of our bouts coming up, and we return on Worldwide Wrestling. Bell sounds, and here we go. Julio Sanchez and Sick Boy to hook it up, and Sick Boy immediately throws Sanchez down.
Yeah, I tell you, the members of the Flock, I mean, they're not pushovers. They're just not all there.
They're all fine wrestlers. I don't think there's any question.
Whoa!
He missed a clothesline, and they dropped toe hold from a Sick Boy, pounding Sanchez in the back of the neck. How about that?
I mean, yeah, they're vicious guys. They're in pretty good condition. But they just have no minds or souls. And Raven, very eerie character, but just eerie when somebody can have that control over so many people.
Oh!
You might get one guy that listens to you, but when you got a flock of them,
all following you around like you're Jim Jones. That's scary.
Air kick down by Sick Boy. Back to the attack again. Well, fans, we're going to be showing you back from WCW Monday Nitro. All right, sleeper hold. Sleeper's what it was. And he got it on him.
He's got it on him, but not good enough.
And a jawbreaker to get out of that. We're going to take you back to Monday Nitro, show you how Bret Hart became the new U.S. champ, how Scott Hall and the Giant won the World Tag Team title, and also how Buff Bagwell reached an all-time low in our sport. Coming up in the course of this program in a Lucha Libre Tag Team feature bout coming up later on.
They better stay on him.
Sick Boy back to the point of attack once again. Sending Julio into the corner. Watch out, here he comes. And Julio moved out of the way. Deep arm drag takedown. Well, no, I get a hip toss that time. Hip tossed him out. Scoop clamp.
But keep throwing him, kid. He's staying on him.
Sick Boy put the brakes on. Need him in the midsection. Sends him in. Another sleeper hold is on. Sick Boy has it hooked on pretty hard. Sanchez picks him up and puts him down belly to back.
Yeah, these guys are putting a sleeper on, but they don't have in the right position in the elbow. When you lock a sleeper on properly, there's no way they can turn their heads out of it like that. These guys, when they go back to the drawing board, they got the right idea, but they don't have the master's touch.
Missed the fist to the face that time. Missed the back elbow.
Foot. His foot
in the face of Sick Boy. Lock the punch. Swinging neck breaker. Drop kick. Sanchez with some offense going here.
What?
Block that fist attempt again and a pickup. Sick Boy. Oh boy. Put him down hard with that one.
A little too slow with that right hand. Sick Boy blocked it.
Going for his pending maneuver. Called the cure, and if he can put it on, there's going to be no getting up for Julio Sanchez. And there won't be. Sick Boy is going to roll him over, and I'm sure get the win. 1, 2, 3. Yes, it's over. How about that?
We'll chalk up one more for the block.
In the persona of Sick Boy.
So does Raven take all these guys? Does Raven get the checks? Oh, that's Kidman. Lice-infected Kidman.
Kidman put him down with a powerbomb, and now Raven in. Sitting down in the corner. What a bizarre man, if you call him that, this Raven is.
Hey, look at his face full of scars. This guy's getting uglier by the week.
For all those tattoos and leather jacket, he'll be away at home in Sturgis. Here it is again.
They won't recognize him in Sturgis, but right there, I mean, nice swinging neck breaker, but he got caught in the clutch of the Sick Boy here, and there was just nowhere to go. Look, he's got the arms hooked, and surfboard position picks him up, just drives him right in the top of his head, right down with all his weight. Sick maneuver from Sick Boy.
Sick Boy is your winner, still to come. The Disco Inferno in singles competition, a Lucha Libre tag team match. Plus, we'll go back to WCW Monday Nitro, where we invite you to listen to this right now.
Buff Bagwell, what a horrible scene that was. And once again, just like I said at the top of the program, we're not taking anything away from a serious injury, but Bagwell certainly fooled us all. And obviously, as you said earlier, Larry, just showing how low NWO Hollywood will go.
You know, I may not look into it as deep as I should because I golf more than I wrestle, but if I was active in the ring, you know, I think Bagwell would have still fooled me. I mean, I thought he saw the light when he came close to never walking again. But, you know, in terms of human chess, if you analyze it, it was a brilliant move by Team Hollywood.
It really was. And the bad news is we talked so much about the serious injury to Buff Bagwell, and it was serious. Rick Steiner underwent shoulder surgery because of a combination of things. The attack by his brother months ago, combined with the wear and tear of the years of pro wrestling. And his shoulder surgery took him down, and they pummeled him too.
Yeah, I know. I mean, Steiner had a serious injury, but Steiner's shoulder is nothing compared to a spinal cord. That's a tinker toy. compared to the central nervous system. And Bagwell fooled us all. But remember, the biggest fool of all is the man who fools himself, Tony. And Bagwell still sold his soul to Hollywood Hulk Hogan.
That's what he did, and that's what they've all done. Bret Hart, Scott Hall for money. The Giant, of course, the new World Tag Team Champions. You've seen all that footage. Fans, as you know, when Goldberg became the world champ back last month, July 6th, defeated Hollywood Hogan, he had to relinquish the United States Heavyweight Championship because of the rules. Can't have two major titles at one time. WCW officials decided DDP and Bret Hart would wrestle for that title. And Bret Hart certainly took the upper hand on that before the match even got started. You've seen all that. Bret Hart's the U.S. Heavyweight champ.
Yeah, I disagree. I thought they should have had a tournament. I mean, the U.S. belt, very prestigious, you know, belt underneath the world title. And I would have liked to have seen a tournament held for it.
Oh, I think you're right. I think we have so many great wrestlers who are in the top 10 as far as contenders are concerned that on any given day they could have won the belt. And it makes for much more excitement. But I can understand with all WCW executive committees got going on right now how they could just...
But they had so many problems with the New World Order, black and white, the black and the red, the chaos created by the presence of Eric Bischoff. That I think they just wanted to make a decision and be done with it. Whoa!
Clothesline out of the ropes by the Disco Inferno.
Wyndham tried to back into that corner, but that might not have been a smart move. Disco's all over him.
Disco's had a lot of fire and vigor and intensity here as he... boots him into the corner. Here he comes again. And he got a foot to the face.
I want to see him dancing with a flat face.
Like Kendall Windham.
Oh, big guy, too. He can reach out and tag you, and he's been around.
His father is, of course, as you fans have been following the sport for years, knows, the legendary Blackjack Mulligan. And I think there's a lot. I see a lot of Blackjack in Kendall. Look how big and burly he is. Look at the black glove he's got on, just like his father used to wear.
Whoa!
Clothesline him down. Covers him. Got a two count.
Yeah, use that extension. Just came right up underneath the chin of the Disco, and this is not the guy in there to dance with. Kendall Windham, you've got to be on your game. Disco's hitting him low, hitting him in them ribs, but not enough steam behind it.
Kendall rakes to the eyes. And gouges once again.
Well, Kendall's, I mean, he's an aggressive guy. He's going to stay on Disco. Disco is not going to get a break from Mr. Windham, and that's smart thinking.
Back elbow that time.
You're right there. I'm surprised Windham's not all over him, but you don't give him much time.
I didn't really at first even notice. Here's a cover, one, two, but Wyndham's got the same type of boots his father used to wear, those cowboy boots, red, black, and white.
Well, the acorn does not fall far from the tree, believe me.
And a rear chin lock. Nick Patrick looks at the Disco Inferno, and Kendall Wyndham glances towards the fence. Travis Tritt's going to be a part of Road Wild. The event is next Saturday, and of course, it was our third year for Sturgis, Larry, and it's a lot of excitement.
Talk about a far-out pay-per-view. Sturgis is the unique pay-per-view of the year. And hey, the atmosphere out there with the countryside and the mountains and the sunsets, very picturesque.
And let me also, while we're talking about, we've been talking about what's been going down, where does Eric Bischoff get off in making a mockery of Jay Leno, even copying Jay Leno's... monologue, his same jokes.
You know, when you imitate somebody, they say it's the biggest form of flattery. I don't know if Bischoff has delusions of grandeur, if he thinks he's a big talk show host now, or anything he wants to. Maybe he's trying. I mean, I don't know what he's doing aside from making a fool out of himself. I don't see what the point is.
A rear chin lock is applied, and
again, I think it's a smokescreen set up by Team Hollywood. They want to get the attention on themselves. They don't want the people cheering for the red and the black, for the wolf pack. They're trying something. I don't think it's working.
They certainly have garnered a lot of belts as of late, even though it may not be working. as some people may think. NWO Hollywood trying to dominate things. In, disco over the top. Sunset flips him down, one, two, and he almost pinned the big man with that sunset flip.
Yeah, got over the tall guy, just didn't have enough. I mean, Kendall's too big to just try to sell a package that way. Disco's too small. He's got to learn how to use his speed and mobility to get these big guys on the ground. I mean, this is not the right approach.
Now, look at this. Stroking the man. It could be a disqualification, although I'm not so sure that even concerns Kendall Windham. Kendall comes through the ropes.
We got 5 legal seconds, and Windham took advantage of 4 9/10 of it.
Very good. You're right on top of it.
9/10
Okay.
Always take it to the limit.
Only you pros can figure out how long 9/10 is.
If you don't live it to the life to the fullest, you may as well jump in the box.
Okay, in the corner. Here he comes. Oh. He clotheslined him in the corner and put him down.
And nowhere to go. Body takes all that shot.
Watch out again. No, he missed him with an attempted elbow on Donbass.
What?
Swinging neck breaker.
What a replay.
And cover, 1, 2, got a 2 count.
Again, too big of a man to cradle up like that, and Disco's, I think that's Phantom. I don't know if we can get him up, no.
Trying to pick this big guy up, back body drop. Disco, trying to get back to his feet. Kendall sends him in, missed an elbow. Into the midsection, watch out. Disco trying to pick him up. Oh, yeah. Big pile driver. Covers, 1, 2. It's over.
Now, this time he did get the cradle. Lock those hands together. And not getting up quick. Tough match against Windham. Anytime you're with Kendall Windham, you've got your hands full. His head's bobbing, but his body ain't dancing.
Fans are having a great time here at Universal Studios, Florida. And let's take it back to the replay. It's our master lock of the night.
Well, look at it right there. Looks like Kendall tried to clothesline him in the corner, but Disco finally started using his speed. Nice swinging neck breaker right there. And this time he got the big man up. And right there, right on the top of the head. I think Kendall Windham's own weight knocked him out.
Master Lock is jumping under fire, so put a brand new Master Lock in your corner with our Lock of the Night. Master Lock, we'll have more at our feature bout. Right now, we invite you to listen to this.
Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall along with the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, and Barbarian. And I've got an issue I wanted to address with you, Jimmy. But first, let me remind everybody about our third annual Road Wild event. It's Saturday, August 8th, coming from Sturgis, South Dakota. Of course, the big motorcycle rally and race. A couple of ways you can be involved. Either number one, you get on your American-made bike and head for the Black Hills of South Dakota. Or just get this one on pay-per-view. Call your cable operator right now. It is on DirecTicket, DirecTV. Of course, the Dish Network has it as well. Satellite owners, please contact Turner Premier. Road Wild, August 8th. It's a Saturday, and we would love to see you there. Now, Jimmy, I've asked you to come out because it seems that Ming is on nothing less than a mission to get to Barbarian. And it's obvious he'll go through you if he has to get to him.
Do I look like a nervous wreck?
Please. You look, Jimmy, I've seen you. You're pale. You're sweating. You look horrible, quite honestly.
I think I've got a fever if you want to know the truth about this. And all because of one person. You, Ming. What have I done to deserve this? What has the Barbarian done to deserve this? You know, when the Barbarian and me were tag-teaming up, I gave them title shot after title shot. Was it my fault, Ming, that you were the weak link of the tag team? He had to suffer for it. I had to suffer for it. All of a sudden, he went away out of our life. And now, all of a sudden, no matter what we're doing, we can't concentrate on the matches because all of a sudden, out of the audience, out of the back, out of the roof, here comes Ming. Well, I am tired of it, and I am through with it because from now on, everywhere I go, the Barbarian or Hugh Morris is going to be with me, right, Barbarian?
What about a Barbarian?
Ming, seems like myself and Jimmy Hart had a business to take in the ring. You stick your nose. Seems like your match. But August 8th, come down just you and me.
It's going to be Road Wild, Sturgis, South Dakota. Fans, the best thing you can do to become part of this great summer event is call your cable operator right now. Sturgis, it's red hot in the summer, and we'd sure love to see you there.
All right, let's take a look at next week's program. Of course, next week is Road Wild Weekend. Living legend Larry Zbysko.
All right, here, big man Hugh Morris again with a master of human chess, Jimmy Hart.
Also from NWO Hollywood, it's going to be Vincent, the director of security, or so they say, of NWO Hollywood. He'll be with us in singles competition.
And a brother-in-law, British Bulldog and Jim the Anvil Neidhart. Two power-packed individuals.
It's all next week during Road Wild Weekend on Worldwide Wrestling. Time for Lucha Libre Tag Team Wrestling.
And anything can happen here now. These guys are, let me get this straight, luchador rules with the tags. They have different tag team rules south of the border.
Well, I know they have those different tag team rules when it comes to six-man tag, but, well, yeah, I would assume for a regular two-on-two tag. Well,
because it's like one can come in when the other guy goes out without tagging sometimes, and if your mask comes off, you commit Harry Carey or something. A very strange rule.
Well, as you see Miano 4-5, you realize that they do a lot of the sneak attacks anyway. One man falling on the outside, the other man pretending to be the first man, and so on and so forth. They'll have to face a team here of Psychosis. And his partner, the very able, the very exciting, never say die, Juventud Guerrero.
Good hopping. But there's two guys that can't pull the old switcheroo. They don't look the same, but we'll see if the Vianos can outdo the movement of Psychosis and Juventud. I don't know, these guys can move. They're going to have to use it, too.
Juventud and Psychosis. And immediately the Vianos take charge. Outside Juventud, and they disrobe now Psychosis.
Hey, smart thing, these guys took advantage of their weight. They immediately slowed down Psychosis and Guerrero. Guerrero, whatever.
Guerrero. Watch out, double chop, in they go. Pick up with a great tag team move. Superb tag team wrestling. Double team. Picked him up. Dropped him down. Firmly on the knees.
And Psychosis isn't getting up. I think he sees the right corner to go to. Want to make a lot of tags here. Psychosis is in trouble. He didn't make it to the corner.
Chop to the rope. Watch out. A pickup. Get the world.
Wow.
Close lined him down. Cover. Only got a one count. Well, the action, fast and furious in Lucha Libre Tag Team Wrestling.
Oh, he walked right into that one again. He's got to make the tag here. Get away from the Viano. He's in the right corner, but I don't know if he knows where he is. He should just reach fast.
Chopped
him. There you go.
Tag has been made. Yeah. How about that? Missile drop kick. Springboard from the top. Moving to showing his fire and determination. That has made him such a star in the cruiserweight circuit.
Yeah, but he was hitting the big man in the chest. Had no effect, not enough weight to do that. He didn't use his movement. He's standing there toe-to-toe with the bigger man, and that's the price you pay.
Chops him down. All right, now for the ride. Sends him in. Pick up. Over the top. Down, and a two count with a sunset flip and a phenomenal move. Reverse kick, spin kick. DDT! Cover, one, two.
Come on, Kimmy!
Yeah, they're grounding the high flyers right here.
Now, Viano 4 dropped Juventud and tags in Viano 5. Well, these guys are a fine tag team.
Yeah, I mean, they should drag them over more towards their corner. Get Juventud as far away from his partner as they can. And he may say surrender.
Into the corner. A pickup again. Another backbreaker. Look at this double team. Up. Boom. And two is sent down by Viano 4. And a cover. One, two.
Go.
Could not get the three count.
Now they got him in the right ring position. That's where you want to keep Juventud. Well, they sure grounded this guy.
And that was the strategy to ground Juventud Guerrero up on top. Roll-in slam that time. And a kick right between the shoulder blades.
Again, keeping their bodies, keeping his body between his partner again. Keep him right in the corner, dunking him in the face. The Anos are looking good here. They've slowed it down to their speed.
Repeated blows, and that's Bull Nelson.
He's going to make the tag.
He did.
He hit the point. He missed him.
Nobody home. But watch out. Viano 4 is up. Could be trouble. Anything can happen in the waning moments of this program. A bumped up. Oh, trying to hit him. Pulled him head first.
Psychosis got him down, but he's got to go. Now, did he just tag there?
Tag has been made. Springboard using the top. Wiped him out. Juventud, head of steam, watch out. Got him with the foot.
Right, smacking him out. Nice nip up. Juven's using his speed now.
Juven, that's his move. One, two, hit beat him.
It's a
hit
beat
him.
Over.
He beat him. Oh, what excitement. What excitement at Worldwide Wrestling
this week. Down to the wire.
Down to the wire was. And that's what makes WCW Worldwide so great each and every week. You never know what's going to happen. Great, evenly matched competition that brings it right down to the wire here on Worldwide Wrestling again.
I tell you, the Vianos were way ahead on points. They grounded Psychosis and Juventud. They used excellent teamwork, but at the end, they combined their speed. Juventud to the right here. It took a turn for the worse for the Vianos. Psychosis just started flying through the air. Juventud using his speed, and it just wound up hitting the nail on the head for Psychosis. Right there when he cold cocked the Vianos. Four or five. Pick a number. It was seven.
Four and five and nine.
Whatever.
Movie driver, Juventud and Psychosis win, and we'll see you next week on Worldwide Wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Road Wild Weekend, and I'm Tony Schiavone, the man to my right, the one, the only, true living legend in professional wrestling, Larry Zbyszko. Yeah. Welcome to Worldwide Wrestling.
You done welcoming everybody? Because I'm still upset at this idiot Dusty Rhodes.
Don't let them upset you, Larry. You're not kidding. Don't let them upset you. But I tell you, we're going into Road Wild this Saturday with one of the most talked about, one of the most interesting tag team matches in a long time, because Hollywood Hogan will team with Eric Bischoff. The Disciple will be in their corner, and they'll take on the team of Diamond Dallas Page and Jay Leno. You heard me right, Jay Leno. His band leader, Kevin Eubanks, will be in their corner. What a tag team, incredible tag team match it's going to be coming up this Saturday.
You know, talk about the unique. I mean, everybody wants to be a wrestler nowadays. We've had football players come in. Kevin Green come in. The Worm Rodman. Carl Malone. Now Jay Leno wants to get in the ring. And believe me, Tony, Bischoff's right about one thing. With that chin, he is a target, brother.
Yeah, but wouldn't you like to see someone, be it Jay Leno, be it Diamond Dallas Page, be it Kevin Eubanks, shut Bischoff's mouth once and for all? I know how you feel about someone from another walk of life coming in trying to be a wrestler. You being
I feel sorry for him. They don't know.
Yeah, but wouldn't you just like to see someone hit him in the mouth and shut it for him?
Yeah, it'd be great. And I'd like to see Diamond Dallas break Bischoff's neck with the diamond cutter, but Jay Leno, I mean, is going to be defenseless. I mean, even Bischoff, and I've been in the ring with him, I mean, a wrestler will wipe his face in the mat. But Bischoff has done kick fighting. I mean, he's not a slouch. He can't punch in the mouth.
No.
And Leno is just an overweight talk show host.
Big clothesline that time from Humorous as he puts down the Gambler. The one count, the debris you see in the ring, fans, are the cards. The deck of 52 the Gambler brings in the ring with him. And Humorous.
The Humorous, nasty guy, ripping up on that nose. Painful, painful thing to do. Jimmy Hart, of course, master of human chess, has been cluing Hugh Morrison in all the dirty little tricks of the trade. And you get a guy 300 and some pounds that can move like Hugh Morris,
All the dirty tricks make him one tough guy.
Knee to the midsection, humerus, puts him down in a rear chin lock once again. Fans, during the course of this program, we have tag team action. The British Bulldog and Jim the Anvil Neidhart will take on the Armstrong brothers. Sick Boy from the Flock will be here. We'll also see, speaking of kickboxers and karate fighters, Jerry Flynn will be with us against Judo Suwa in a match. And from NWO Hollywood, Vincent will be in singles competition as well.
I mean, talk about Hollywood Hogan. I mean, if he gets his hands on Jay Leno, as much as you despise his ego and what Hogan's become and stands for, I mean, you'll face the fact Hogan would break Jay Leno in half.
Of course he would, and I'm sure it's going to be Leno's job to make sure that when Hogan's in the ring, that DDP is on the other end as
that,
well.
That's easy to say and hard to do. I mean,
oh, big clothesline up on the middle turnbuckle. Humorous. He's going all the way up top. No, laughing matter. Lands on the midsection. One, two. This one's over.
Yeah, big agile guy and Jimmy Hart right there to coach him on. Fill that young head with old school ideas, and believe me, tradition knows how to hurt you.
This is your fault, Jimmy Hart. Then bring me back. Guess what? We're back.
Humorous and Jimmy Hart have a little chuckle to the camera as we're going to take you back to what went down early on in this match. And that means legend.
But right here, watch Hugh Morris. I mean, he springs off and just uses all of his weight. He's got an arm 20-some inches in his chest. Got to be like 56. I mean, and he flies all that way off the rope right across the stomach. And he even crunched his knees on that one, but it's over.
Your winner, Humorous, on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. Coming up next, NWO Hollywood Vincent. But right now, let's take you to Lee Marshall this week on Worldwide Wrestling.
Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall, and we are now getting down to the short strokes, the proverbial 11th hour. I'm talking about Road Wild. If you have not made plans to get this one on pay-per-view, then fans, call your cable operator right now. It's also available on Direct Ticket with DirecTV. Those of you with the Dish Network, you can pick it up there. And satellite owners, of course, you can call Turner Premier. But do it right away, because Road Wild, coming up live from Sturgis, literally in just a couple of hours. A most interesting match has been added to Road Wild. It features Chavo Guerrero Jr., and I'm glad to see that Chavo is at least, for the moment, put down Pepe, the hobby horse. You're no longer at least... but just don't worry about Pepe. You've got a much bigger, and I mean that most literally, a very big assignment coming up. Let's talk about Big Heat, Stevie Ray. Man, do you have your hands full.
The television champion.
Well, now, wait a minute. Hold on a second. He claims to be television champion. You know, there's still a little...
Wait. He says he's TV champ.
Well, he says a lot of things. I mean, Stevie...
He's got the belt.
Well,
right?
You know, I've got a wallet. That doesn't mean I got a lot of money.
He's the TV champion, as far as I'm concerned. You are the TV champion.
I hope that that's true, Chavo, because I'd like to see you get a shot at the World Television Championship that, let's just say, hypothetically, Stevie Ray indeed...
A shot?
Yes.
I don't need a shot. After I win the television championship, you know what I'm going to do with it?
What?
Just me and Eddie are actually kind of getting along now. Eddie,
really?
Yeah, oh, God.
Well,
we're patching things up. It's really
wonderful
great. I really
news.
Love it. I think he's going to shave his head just like me. It's going to be great. Just me, him, and Grandma, all the shaved heads. After I win the television championship, Eddie, I'm going to give it to you as a peace offering. How's that?
This really does muddy up this whole World TV Championship, because Stevie Ray says that Booker T signed it over to him. You say that if you win, you're going to give it over to you. Yeah, this really... Fans, I'm telling you, it's Road Wild coming up live in a couple of hours from Sturgis, South Dakota. Call your cable operator right now.
Hey, legend Larry Zbyszko, you've made it abundantly clear. This Saturday, you think that Jay Leno is making a mistake. Fans, as you know by now, Jay Leno, that's right, of The Tonight Show, will team with Diamond Dallas Page. Kevin Eubank will be in their corner against the team of Hollywood Hogan and Eric Bischoff, the disciple in their corner. Jay Leno has agreed to go in the ring for the first time ever. On the other side, Eric Bischoff and Hollywood Hogan.
We know Jay Leno may look over and see Bischoff and want to take a shot at him, but Bischoff is not that big of a slouch. And the world knows Hollywood Hulk Hogan. If he gets his hands on Leno, he's going to break the man in half. All the responsibility and all the pressure is on Diamond Dallas Page. And only Diamond Dallas Page can
control this matchup. Question is, can he keep Hollywood away from him?
Plus a big NWO Battle Royal, and fans will get great tag team action later on in this program. Right now, though, let's go back to the ring on Worldwide.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following is a one-fall contest. Introducing first from Dallas, Texas, Frankie Lancaster.
Frankie Lancaster, he calls himself Frankie the Thumper, comes out, got quite an attitude. But don't forget, in this matchup, fans, you must go in against a member of NWO Hollywood, one of your good friends here, living legend.
Don't even say that.
Boy, you're talking about one man mad at the black and the white, my colleague right here, Larry Zbyszko. Let's talk about that in just a moment. Right now, back to go to David Pinzer.
His opponent, representing the black and white of the New World Order, from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania,
the music irritates me, and then I gotta hear Vincent from my hometown of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Wow. I like to slap him in the mouth along with that idiot mumbling moron, Dusty Rhodes.
Can you believe he had the audacity to tell me he was the greatest color commentator we ever had?
That's why they fired him.
Well, Vince, when we come back, Vincent and Frankie the Thumper Lancaster will go one-on-one. We'll be talking more about the big event coming up this Saturday at Sturgis and Worldwide after this time out on Worldwide Wrestling. Stay with us. Welcome back to Worldwide Wrestling. Road Wild this Saturday. Not only Jay Leno on one side of the ring with Diamond Dallas as his partner and his band leader Kevin Eubanks in his corner against Hollywood Hogan and Eric Bischoff with the Disciple in the corner, but also, back elbow. Also, it's going to be red and black and white and black in a gigantic battle royal pitting members of the New World Order against each other this coming Saturday, Larry.
Well, that's the good news out of the whole situation here, because I'm worried about Leno. I didn't think that maybe the last time. I mean, he'll never last as long as Johnny Carson. But, you talk about the breakdown of the New World Order because of guys like Vincent here who just have no soul. You can't trust them. They don't care. Look at him. He's a moron. But now you've got them battling amongst each other. Let them hurt each other. Let them get rid of each other. Let them stab each other in the back. Time for WCW to regroup.
And I really think in many ways WCW has been doing just that. Say what they want to, the still world champ, the man who's still on top of things, is the undefeated Goldberg, the heavyweight champion of the world.
And believe me, it's the momentum of Goldberg that's got the New World Order at each other's throats. Both sides want the gold, both sides want the prestige. And Vincent missed!
Hand to the head that time. And a jawbreaker by Frankie the Thumper here.
Thought I saw some teeth fly. He's got me left anyway. He's wobbling.
The fans here are starting to chant Wolfpack. Some of that red and black coming through here on the t-shirts in the stands. And Vincent. Down on the arm. Boy, that'll break an arm.
Yeah, he's right on the elbow and here with the wrist lock just pulling up, all pressure on the wrist, bending back in the elbow, all the way down his shoulder. Vincent got a nasty little hold there, the moron.
Vincent gets the win for the white and the black, NWO Hollywood.
2-3, baby. 2-3.
He's still talking, but we decided to go to another camera and ignore him right now. Go ahead, Larry.
Well, you can't ignore Vincent in the ring. I mean, this guy, he's not bad as much as I like to say. He knows what he's doing right there. Frankie the Thumper got with him, but just couldn't follow it up. Vincent hit him with a nice hook. What a disgrace to Pittsburgh.
It's our Castrol GTX Torture Test of the Week. Castrol GTX is motor oil that stands up to the most torturous conditions. We invite you to listen to this.
Boy, yes, you can bellow it out, can't you?
I get paid by the word.
You wish.
Yeah, you're not kidding. Judo Suwa comes out. He'll face Jerry Flynn in our next matchup. Well, living legend. A lot of talk about what's going to be happening at Road Wild. It'll be our third year in Sturgis, South Dakota, this coming Saturday with the great motorcycle rally they have there. And I know you're going to be around the very next day in Rapid City, as we just saw, for WCW Monday Night. What a great part of the country. to spend a weekend in the Rapid City, Sturgis area with the Mount Rushmore. And
well, I got a couple of little buddies of mine I'm going to take up and show them the mound. They have the gravy hearts they're building in the giant rock with the devil key where the flying saucers came in. So we're all set.
A couple of your buddies?
Casinos.
Same guys you had with you in Las Vegas recently?
Same people.
Same people. Okay, Jerry Flynn comes out against Judo Suwa. Judo Suwa, one of the young men who have trained exclusively under the guidance of the Ultimo Dragon. And Jerry Flynn is laying right into it. Jerry Flynn has become quite a respected veteran in our sport.
Yeah, he's picking up a lot more mad techniques here, Flynn. Again, Flynn Moore, the veteran here, has been kickboxing a lot longer than Judo Suwa here. And very aggressive guy, but Suda got one in.
Drove a shoulder in that time, it appeared to me.
Yep, I second that.
Snapmare takeover, send him down. Waistlock takeover. How about that? Judo Suwa not using the karate judo thrust. He's going for the mat technique, and that time he ran him over with a left-handed clothesline and put him down hard.
You caught him off guard. I don't think Suda expected that clothesline from Flynn. Again, he did. You know, Judo Suwa took Flynn over nicely, but didn't hold on to him, didn't lock him down, and make the cover. But again, that was his mistake. He took Flynn over, but he let him go. Take a man down, you don't let him go.
Not at all. Full-arm dragon twist into a top wrist lock now. Here's Jerry Flynn with the height advantage. Oh, boy, there's a...
We're watching the Three Stooges.
He really has, as Judo Suwa. Suwa uses that to get the advantage now, sending Jerry Flynn in. Knee to the midsection. And a cover, one, two, we got a two count. Only a two count.
You know, I'm really worried about Diamond Dallas Page here, Tony. You didn't realize the pressure on this guy. Because he knows Jay Leno's his responsibility. He knows Jay Leno shouldn't be in the ring. And he knows that if he's not smart, it'll be the end of Jay Leno.
You know what I really hope happens, and I understand Leno is certainly putting a lot of risk here this Saturday when he gets in the ring from a very... Fans, we're talking about Jay Leno, the host of the Tonight Show on NBC. Yes, he's wrestling in the ring, and he'll be at Sturgis this Saturday at Road Wild. But what also I hope happens as a result of this, I hope it puts an end to this horrible thing called NWO Nightcap that we see on Nitro. That is a horrible signal.
Can't we work out something with the pyro people?
You mean to
just blow it up?
To blow it up? Maybe so. I just
move
I'd
the
like,
pyro over.
Yeah, I'd like to see someone destroyed. I mean, who in the world came up with a cross arm breaker now by Jerry Flynn on Judo Suwa? And Suwa's gonna actually tap out there. He tapped on his opponent's knee to tap out. And Jerry Flynn secures a win. It's a big win for him. And this veteran continues to get the wins here on Worldwide Wrestling.
Isn't that horrible? I mean, watching Bischoff imitate Leno is like somebody dragging their fingernails across a chalkboard.
It'd be like me taking my shirt off pretending I'm in the ring.
Yeah, that's true. Anyway, it's a nice spin reverse kick by Flynn. Nice technique right there. Judo Suwa is just a little too young and inexperienced and not quite aggressive enough to keep up with Jerry Flynn, who picture perfectly just dropped him right in the back of his neck and pressed on for the victory. I had a nice little submission hold, used him legs, kicked it over, and then just yanked back.
It had been all fun and bantering back and forth until recently on Nitro. Hollywood Hogan had something serious to say to Jay Leno. It all happened on NWO Nightcap. Road Wild, it is this Saturday, fans, and of course, you great wrestling fans who've joined us over the past 2 years know how much fun we have in Sturgis, South Dakota. Well, we're going to multiply that this year. As a new look, Hard Body Harrison comes out. This year, Travis Tritt, country music superstar, will be in concert as well. And the greatest action in the world, including, can you imagine in one night, such mega stars in the media as, admittedly, Hollywood Hogan, Jay Leno of The Tonight Show, Travis Tritt of country music, and it's all one center stage, and that is Sturgis and the Great Sturgis Rally. You know, Leno's a motorcycle enthusiast, so we had heard he would be in Sturgis this weekend anyway. Now he's going to step into the ring.
But yeah, Leno likes to ride bikes, and I can see that because I like to ride them too. I had a big old 64 panhead chopper with the suicide shift, but killed myself, so I got one with a regular shift. But
I tell you, I still don't think the man should be in the ring. And Diamond Dallas has a responsibility that, you know, if I was him, that you know you have. And Hogan is a big, tough guy. He could break Leno's neck like a matchstick. And I don't know if Leno fully realizes that.
And I don't know if he does or not. But if nothing else, nothing else, this Saturday, live from Sturgis, if one thing happens, I think we'll all enjoy it, and that would be DDP holding Bischoff's arms and Leno paintbrushing Bischoff back and forth. Love to see that happen if nothing else.
I'm sure Leno would, too, after this mockery Bischoff's making of the tradition set down by Johnny Carson and Jack Parr now being carried on by Jay. I mean, insulting.
Yeah, when you talk about the Tonight Show, you're talking about the late night standard, the one that began late night talk.
It's like talking about WCW. It's tradition.
Back elbow by Sick Boy. Put Hard Body Harrison down very hard. Here's a counter one. I understand Hard Body Harrison has been a young man. Of course, we remember the blonde dreadlocks he had not too long ago. A different look, and he's been entering some of these tough man contests around the country and faring quite well.
Well, Hard Body loves to fight him, and he keeps himself in good shape. Probably did something with the hair. A lot of these guys, they're into, like, luck omens or something. I mean, if it didn't work, but again, long hair, people keep grabbing it. So Hard Body went the other way. And I remember when John Daly shaved his head and then won a big PGA championship.
That's right.
Sometimes it's the opposite of the Samson effect. Oh, maybe not. Didn't work for Samson.
No, didn't work for Samson. And, of course, well, you never know. That reminds me of something I wanted to get to. You know, you see a guy here with not much hair on his head by the name of Barry Darso, who wrestles, likes to break arms. I understand he's a pretty darn good golfer, too. I understand he's a scratch golfer. Have you heard that?
Are you kidding me? Barry Darso shoots off his mouth.
Okay.
He likes to play golf, but he's horrible.
All right.
He's a hacker.
Here's an inside cradle. I don't want to start anything between you and Darso because...
just compared to golfers, I mean...
Okay, well... Yeah. Sick Boy taking all kinds of shortcuts.
Well, he didn't say he could beat me, did he?
Nope, didn't talk to him. Don't want to talk to him. Just
get your checkbook, kid.
He just wanted to start something, and I obviously was very successful in doing so. Into the corner. You're easy, Larry. To the other side.
Well, it's golf you're talking about, and move.
Okay, moved out of the way. Knee to the midsection. And he peels him out. Good move that time by Hard Body. Covers him. Got a one count.
Go.
Jump kick. One, two, got a two count.
Almost. He gave him a couple of good shots right here.
Drop toe hold by Sick Boy. How about that?
Yeah, something you don't expect Sick Boy to do, drop toe hold you, but he's smart enough to stay on you, pounding Hard Body in the back of the neck. Hard Body's looking wobbly here, but no, he's got good endurance. See what he can do with it.
Over the top. Look at the agility by Sick Boy. Uh-oh. Got him hooked. Could be his move. It is. It's called the cure. And it put him out. It's over.
The cure.
The cure.
This guy needs the cure.
Well, you're not kidding. And the cure is going to be our focus of our master lock of the night. So take it away there, Fresh
Dog. I'm waiting for the beat. You know, it's interesting right here. Something Hard Body didn't expect. Sick Boy right there gone, but it was a drop toe hold that took him down at the end and let Sick Boy come in for the victory. Just kind of a master of the lock.
Put a tough new master lock in your corner. Master lock, tough under fire. Let's take you to this.
Over the past few weeks, we have seen a very interesting development in WCW, and I'm hoping my guest can help me figure this out and help the fans as well, as we're now just a couple of hours away from Road Wild, that spectacular event from Sturgis, South Dakota. We are talking about emotions running wild. Emotions on behalf of Saturn, on behalf of Raven, and on behalf of Canyon. And in just a couple of hours, it all comes to a head in the shadows of the Black Hills of South Dakota at Road Wild. Fans, I encourage you right now, call your cable operator, get this one on pay-per-view. Dish owners, please call Turner Premier. It's also on Direct Ticket with DirecTV. Saturn, it's really, I guess, a triangle match now between you, Canyon, and Raven, a three-way dance that we've been talking about. But it's a matter of who do you trust going into a match like that? Let me ask you, who do you trust?
First of all, figuring this out is easy. Canyon's a kid who can't keep his nose out of everybody else's business. And Raven's a crybaby, always getting somebody else to fight for him. Well, this triangle match, three-way dance, I'm going to dump them both on their heads. It's going to be that simple.
Well, I thought that maybe the reason you couldn't get along with Canyon was you both hated Saturn. I mean, you both hated Raven so severely, it was a matter of who could get their hands on him first. I think you were upset with Canyon because he interfered in a match in which you were beating the living K-Pac out of Raven.
The problem with Canyon is he's so starved for attention that he keeps interfering with other people's business. He should learn to stay to himself, and I'm going to teach him.
Well, it's going to be a very violent match, that's for sure, as this man, Saturn, gets in the ring with two other men who also have a most violent streak. I speak of Canyon and Raven. What a triangle match that is going to be, and it's all part of the action you can see exclusively on pay-per-view. It's WCW and Road Wild. Fans, I encourage you again as we get down literally now to the 11th hour. A few hours remain until we begin this program. Call your cable operator or call Turner Premier.
Well, next week on WCW Worldwide Wrestling, the week after Road Wild, it's going to be a big week here because we've got some tag team action. Rocco Rock, Johnny Grudge, Public Enemy will be with us next week, Living Legend.
And again, the wiggling, squirming little wonder kid, Alex Roy.
He'll be with us, and now watch out. One extreme to the other. Oh, Hacksaw Jim Duggan joined us in singles competition.
And again, Stevie Ray, a man on a mission to bring his brother back home, will be on Worldwide.
That'll be all next week here on Worldwide Wrestling, and we go to our feature bout and tag team wars. Well, we also know this coming weekend, this Saturday, Chris Jericho will defend the Cruiserweight belt against Juventud Guerrera, and Dean Malenko has been named the special referee for this matchup. He can't wrestle Jericho again, but he can get in the ring as a referee, and I would hope that he would cheat, that he would stretch the rules, that he would make it impossible for Jericho to retain the title.
Oh, I'm sure Malenko will be fair and square. Oh, my nose has got bigger.
I'm sure he won't. It'd be interesting. Well, the eyes of not only the wrestling world, but the entertainment world out in Hollywood, California, of course, another media capital in New York City, all on what will happen when Jay Leno gets the tag and walks into the ring for the first time ever as a pro wrestler this Saturday.
I tell you, knowing the television business, I've been Letterman and all the rest of the talk show hosts, probably hoping Hogan breaks Leno's neck so they don't have competition, but hey, that could be a very easy reality. Leno has no idea what he's getting into. Hogan, I mean, you can break him in half, and the responsibility on the shoulders of Diamond Dallas Page. Not only with Bischoff in there, who's no slouch in terms of, you know, punching somebody, but now they got the disciple in the corner. So the band leader, I mean, they're really outmatched, Tony, and this is going to be hard on Diamond Dallas Page.
It's all coming up this Saturday. You can make the call and join us. If you have cable with pay-per-view, if you have DirecTV, Direct Ticket is your source. If you have the large satellite dish, you can contact Turner Premier, of course, also available on the mini dish with the Dish Network as well. Forget about it. Armstrong trying to run over Jim the Anvil Neidhart, but living up to his name, he's an Anvil. He gets a two count. Oh. And how about the quickness?
Well, again, Anvil saw him coming. Armstrong's hurt himself. I'm telling you, the curse of the Armstrong still lives.
Very well could. And here comes the British Bulldog pounding away.
Yeah, powerful man, British Bulldog. Knows how to hurt you, too. He'll fight you, you know, the drop of a hat, or he'll wrestle you. He's good on the mat. Armstrong boy, just smart to double-team him as much as possible.
All right, watch out. In he goes. Duck low. British Bulldog kicks him. Oh, look at this gorilla. Press slam. What power. Down he goes. There. Steve Armstrong get in, and he took the low road.
Well, he saw. He made eye contact, so no way he's sneaking up on the Bulldog now.
Jim Neidhart, the Anvil in. Good double team work here by the British Bulldog and Jim the Anvil Neidhart.
Yeah, good team positioning too. Again, there's something Jay Leno doesn't know anything about that's so vital. Ring positioning and tag team theory and
I mean, he can't possibly be a partner or a help to Diamond Dallas.
Double action. No, no, I don't think he wants to be. I think it's a personal vendetta that he wants to settle.
The vendetta is not the point. The point is the situation, and Leno's going to get murdered.
All right, there's only one way you can find out. That's to join us this Saturday. A little jawing going back and forth there between the two teams. Scott Armstrong will send him in. Duck low. Neidhart over. Neidhart over.
There's no referee.
There he is. One, two.
Only. Armstrong was smart there. Tried to keep the referee away as long as possible. See if they can break the curse.
Here's the Bulldog to get in, and then he was a double team on the other side. Well, there you see Mark Curtis on the Bulldog outside. Take it away. Meanwhile, a chokehold applied on the ribcage, on the chest.
I'm telling you, the curse has finally cracked the Armstrong boys. These guys getting a lot more aggressive, a lot more nasty, breaking a lot more rules, using all the tricks of the trade here, doing anything to get a winning streak. I mean, on paper, they're great, but the curse has kept them down.
Forearm shot, and again, back and forth they go. Neither man giving an inch here. Scott Armstrong obviously doesn't have the size of Jim Neidhart, is willing to go in and pound away against the big man.
Now the anvil's way too thick. The upper body of this man's like a horse. He's trying to push his way to the Bulldog. Look at the face on the anvil. He's just getting redder, but he's going.
He's going to get there. Going to make a tag. Here comes the Bulldog.
No, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Referee did not see it. You got to be kidding me.
That's great technique by the Armstrong boys. And that's, again, that's what Leno's up against. He doesn't have a clue.
All right. Front chancery applied now by Scott. And Anvil, well, trying to get away, but Scott won't let go. How about that? Showing some great arm strength and power as well.
Oh, you hooked that head underneath, trying to get away. Caught the Bulldog sleeping.
Still with a front chancery.
Taking his time, not trying to make any mistakes.
Squishy. Jim Neidhart. A wild swing. And tag is made. Now the Bulldog. A clothesline. Another one. Three of them. Make it four. Four clotheslines. Four clotheslines in a row.
He had him rocking with the Armstrongs. They put it to a stop.
And a clothesline from behind. And another one. Oh, my goodness. We've seen a total of six. One, two, three, it's over.
You gotta be kidding.
Unbelievable.
The curse lives, I'm telling you.
Out of nowhere.
The curse of the Armstrong.
Out of nowhere. Six clotheslines in a row. Call them, Larry.
Well, two.
Thank you.
Three.
Okay, go ahead. Say it again.
Four.
And that was just the beginning.
You know, we should put an over-under on these clotheslines. I tell you, the Armstrong tried to have great ring positioning, but the power of the Bulldog and the anvil, I think, was just too much complicated by the fact that with this last clothesline, they hit the over. The curse of the Armstrongs lives on.
What a day, and what a weekend. This Saturday is the weekend for Road Wild. Travis Tripp.
It's WCW World Championship Wrestling, and this is Worldwide. Hi, everybody. It's Tony Schiavone, and the one, the only real legend in professional wrestling, Larry Zbyszko. For the next hour, you're hooked into some of the greatest stars in pro wrestling.
Hello there, young lady.
Stop it.
Is that a friend of yours, Larry?
She looks like one.
Boy, she sure does. All the beautiful.
I think she could qualify.
All the beautiful women love the living legend, and we're great to have you. It's great to have you with us. Todd Griffith, a young, powerful man, is making his way to the ring, but he must face in this opening bout, living legend, quite a star and a man who's really in the center of a lot of controversy. We're talking about Stevie Ray.
You know, Stevie Ray personally came up to me, Tony, and he was telling me that he's not jealous of Booker T. He doesn't have any animosity towards his brother. He's doing it for his brother's benefit.
I'm giving this sucker 10 seconds to get out of the ring, and I'm going to give him a chance to save himself.
Why not this sucker? I mean, his brother.
I understand.
But he says that his brother's been out stepping with the man, coming out of limos with J.J. Dillon, and he just wants to bring Booker T back home, back to his past, back to his roots. But I don't know, when I find out lately about people finding little notary seals in the locker room, makes you wonder what Stevie Ray's motives really are.
I think Stevie Ray wants to do much like what Chris Jericho has done concerning the cruiserweight belt. He wants to become the champion without actually having to win the belt or earn it in the ring. Now, hopefully in the weeks to come, we will find out the true story of the World Television title. Did Booker T really give that belt to him or not? That remains to be seen, but right now, Stevie Ray and Todd Griffin will hook it up in this opening bout. Hey, fans, we've got Public Enemy in tag team action. Larry, I know you're always excited when Public Enemy comes in and knocks them down.
You never know what you're going to do.
Yeah, I know you don't. Plus, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. And how about Captain Lismanoff, Rey Mysterio Jr., and Psychosis to go one-on-one later on in this program?
Yeah, and that's going to be wild, these luchadors. I mean, daredevils that they are. I like to watch them because you never know when they're going to be carried out in a stretcher.
Here's a pickup. Oh, boy. Put him down. That's raw power right there.
Yeah, Stevie Ray, big, strong guy. I mean, you can look at him and you will not be deceived. He is a powerful man, and he can move that weight. I think he just knocked out the camera guy.
Put the brakes on after hitting each rope. Back and forth, and I thought maybe a guillotine leg drop, but no, he just stomped the man on the chest. Please, Stevie Ray, truly one of the strongest men in our sport, but what an attitude. And I realize that the attitude comes from, you know, his years in the sport, growing up on 110th Street in Harlem, New York, growing up the tough life, but he has taken it into the ring, and he's made it mean something. Moving out of the way, Todd Griffith, and Griffith couldn't even roll him up that time. It looked like Griffith wanted to try to follow up with something, but had nothing to follow up with.
Now, it's like Griffith maybe should take Stevie Ray's advice and head for the lockers. But Stevie Ray's been all over him from the beginning. And I don't think this kid's got anything left except a head full of hair. Maybe.
Now, after all those great offensive moves, Stevie Ray resorts to choking the man, and there's Nick Patrick in his face right now.
Stevie Ray does not look like a man full of brotherly love for Booker T or anybody, does he?
No, there's more than meets the eye there. There's a clothesline.
Yeah, he missed the first one.
Missed the first one, but the second attempt in this first match.
Adds up to two.
Adds up to, yes it does. Thank you. Hooks him now.
Now you're going to feel slapjack.
His move is called the slapjack, and already with a double underhook, he's caught for it. Talking about a 300-pound frame on the back of the head. Count this man out. It's over.
Well, he slammed him down. Todd Griffith better keep that hair. He can hang it over his newly flattened face.
Todd Griffith just had nothing. Stevie Ray overwhelmed him with his speed and power. And look, swing at a referee. Did he try to clothesline a referee there?
I think he just tried to knock Patrick silly, but I don't blame him for that. Referees are annoying people.
All right, let you go ahead.
Well, right here, Stevie Ray. What an elbow that just jarred the whole body of Todd Griffin. That was a good late shot in here. Just big man, too much power, and this was the coup de grace. He just flattened.
Get your dancing shoes on. Alex Wright is next, but right now we send you to another one, Lee Marshall.
Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall here. In just a couple of seconds, you're going to meet a man who has been the headliner at our last two pay-per-views, and he's had some very unusual and interesting tag team partners. And on the subject of pay-per-views, I scan the calendar to see September 13th in the horizon, and that is our next pay-per-view. It's WCW and Fall Brawl. There's a couple of ways for you to be part of this. Join us live, if you would. Drop by the Lawrence Joel Coliseum in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, on Sunday, September 13th. If you're not in the area, don't worry about it. You can see this one by contacting your cable operator and getting this on pay-per-view. It's also going to be on DirecTicket with DirecTV and Dish Network Viewers, you can see Fall Brawl. Satellite owners, all you need to do is contact Turner Premier. It's Fall Brawl, September 13th. It's a Sunday. We're going to start at 6:30. Well, the last couple of pay-per-view events have featured Diamond Dallas Page and a medley of great athletes and certainly interesting celebrities as tag team partners. And each time, you have really lived up to what I think has been your credo, and that's turning a negative into a positive. You've taken basketball players, made credible wrestlers out of them. You've taken Jay Leno and made a heck of a partner out of him. You have really turned the ultimate negative into the absolute positive.
Well, I think more than anything, the thing that I had so much in common with Karl Malone was his work ethic. This guy works as hard as anybody I've ever seen in anything, in the gym, when he's training for his games, when he's training for preseason, what he does to regiment himself, and I knew about his work ethic. Now, if you look at a guy for Hollywood, Jay Leno, which we just think, Jay Leno in the ring, well, he didn't do too bad, man.
Not at all.
But it was mainly about his preparation. Flew a ring out there, set it up, brought about some of my guys, and got them ready to go. Bottom line is, when I get to Lawrence Joel Coliseum, I'll be ready to go. Because that heart, right here. And if I do get in the ring with somebody, they are getting banged.
We're back on Worldwide Wrestling still to come. Lucha Libre single competition. Rey Mysterio Jr. back in action right here this week on Worldwide. But Living Legend, as we head now into the fall months, head towards Fall Brawl in the month of September. It gets more bizarre, involving the New World Order, both white and black, and red and black. We've seen a white and black Sting, a red and black Sting. We've seen Bret Hart said he wants to be Sting's friend, but teaming with members of the white and the black. What's going on in the NWO?
You know, I think the same scenario, Tony, that happened between WCW and the original New World Order. Now we've got a group of men who hate each other, who don't trust each other, and are all fighting for supremacy of the wrestling world.
Let's go back to the ring.
He's set for one fall. Introducing first, from Nuremberg, Germany, Alex Wright.
Well, get on your dance and choose. That's Wonder Kid. Alex Wright has arrived.
Doesn't exactly look like he'd fit into the glass slippers, does he?
No, but Alex Wright has returned. He and the Disco Inferno and the man from Japan, Tokyo Magnum, have taken to do more dancing than their wrestling over the past couple of months.
Yeah, it looks like his biggest phobia is coming true.
And that is?
He's getting bald, his hair's checking out. His dad was bald, and Alex feared the hereditary consequence.
Now his opponent in this matchup will be Tim Keats here on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. And fans, when we come back, our next match, don't forget, Rey Mysterio Jr. Psychosis to go one-on-one, still coming up on Worldwide Wrestling. And we'll be back into the short timeout for action with Alex Wright, Tim Keats. Welcome back, fans, and it's Alex Wright and Tim Keats. Immediately, Tim Keats plays on the patriotic theme. The fans start to chant USA, but hey, let's not forget there are a lot of fans that come to Universal Studios Florida that are from Europe or from Germany and are big fans of Alex Wright and, of course, his father.
Ones chanting USA. Even they don't like the new attitude of Alex Wright here.
I don't think anybody, with the exception of maybe Disco Inferno and Tokyo Magnum, like Alex Wright and his attitude and his...
it's too bad because Alex Wright's a good wrestler, but he kind of like lost faith in himself and taking his shortcuts, and Cheeks was a little short there.
Great takedown by Alex Wright. Elbows to the side of the head. And Alex Wright up on top. Wait, Alex Wright, a lot more vicious than we've seen him in recent weeks.
Yeah, I mean, he's got aggressive again. I think he's learned the hard way. I mean, nice guys finish last, but that doesn't mean you throw away the science, because they'll take advantage of it. Alex Wright has to know how to control that emotion.
That's the key, the control. The great heel move by Tim Cheeks, and follows it up with a nice drop kick and sends Alex Wright all the way to the floor.
Well, he's thinking. I mean, the kid's thinking.
Hey, those kids better leave him alone there at ringside.
What'd they do to him?
No, they just need to leave the wrestlers alone. Look like a bunch of brats there at ringside anyway. Into the midsection, Alex Wright. Full arm dragon twist. And a good reversal by Tim Cheeks. Oh, great athletic ability. Cartwheeled out of it.
Yeah, Alex got the moves. Plus, I mean, he's a tall kid. He's
Actually, bigger than he looks. He's about 6 foot five. He's real lean.
Snap, suplex, and a bridge, and a two count.
Oh, no. He's not quite there yet.
As long as he would rather dance than wrestle, I don't think he's ever going to be quite there yet. Just an opinion, but usually, oh boy.
I bet him and the Disco Inferno can have some great conversations.
Yeah,
talking about themselves.
Alex up and down, Kimchi. Almost got him, but Foo was on the ropes. Alex Wright, angry with Charles Robinson that can stop the count. But the referee, right on target on that one. Oh. Like a good old knife edge chop to the chest. Into the rope. Missed a clothesline. Cross body. One, two.
Couldn't hold him.
Oh, boy. He blocked the clothesline with a drop kick.
How do you block a clothesline with a drop kick?
Alex Wright did it. I can't explain it, but I know that's what happened.
I thought that's what I saw.
I know that was an attempt at a clothesline, and I know he drop kicked him.
We're like scissors, rock, and paper. Drop kick nullifies the clothesline.
In many ways, I'm not going yet. A chap running into the foot. That one glanced off the back of the head. Alex Wright, that blocked. And Tim Cheeks has come to fight here this week.
Hey, he's not giving up, Cheeks. I mean, not giving up.
Drop kick. Sometimes, Larry, one match can turn a man's career around. Could this be the match for Tim Cheeks?
I tell you, it happened to Goldberg.
Certainly did. And he's never looked back.
Well, hit him, kid.
Looking out of the fans, wasting a lot of time, although he is rocking ahead of Alex Wright. Noma! Dropped him down across the top rope. Reverse neck breaker.
Doesn't look good for Cheeks.
Wow. You know what that tells me? That when he gets focused, when he wants to, when he's determined, Alex Wright can end the match, can win, because the man is a very talented wrestler.
He's got the ability. Again, the antics Alex Wright pulled off here against Mr. Cheeks are things he won't be able to get away with when he moves up to the top level of competition. Take another look here, and you'll see Cheeks went up, got him right in the rib area. Not quite enough to get the air out of Alex Wright. This was a good snap, and Cheeks wasn't counting out of this one.
Hungry, why wait? Grab a Snickers with our Snickers replay. Your winner, Das Wunderkind Alex Wright. Public Enemy and tag team action when we come back. But right now, we invite you to listen to this. Public Enemy in the house. And you can see by the way the fans are standing, moving their arms back and forth, that they're excited about Rocco Rock and Johnny Grunge. So are we. Always an entertaining night, entertaining match when they come out, because I tell you, they don't have the big, beautiful bodies like a Lex Luger, but they give it their all when they wrestle, Larry.
Well, they're unpredictable. You can see even Rocco Rock walking behind Johnny Grunge has a mask on, so you can imagine the odor following Johnny Grunge. Never walk behind Johnny Grunge.
Well, I don't
know. Got a mask on. But then they set that table up, and right away their opponents are thinking, could be my body getting all full of splinters and those things. Because they're not bringing it into the ring, it's not an illegal object.
No, it's not, but you know, a lot of times when you see them use the table, I think splinters would be the least of my worries. I think I'd be worried about a broken back or a cracked rib or something.
What a metal bar is coming through your intestines.
Well, that's a nuts.
Scary stuff, yeah, I'm telling you,
that. I can visualize that right now. The belt's out. David Fincher, as always, takes the low road, and here we go. As our ring announcer quickly got out of the ring, the bell sounds, and Tony Carr and Dusty Wolf, the opponents for Johnny Grunge and Rocco Rock.
Oh.
It's a double clothesline.
Another one.
Another one. And already.
Wait a minute. I tell you, at least they're smart enough to get out of there. Public Enemy, great tag team. These guys work together well, and it's not easy to get an advantage off these guys off the bat. So
feel pretty confident here.
I mean, fans, you know by watching this sport for years that if there's any team that uses the lariat to the clothesline to their advantage, it's Public Enemy. They are the masters of the clothesline. Forearm shot, back of the ropes. Tony Carr, reversal. Rocco rocks into him in, and Tony Carr runs over it. Rocco down low. Ducking. Great back body drop.
Some hang time for Tony.
To the side of the head. Rocco rock in. Yep. Oh, boy. Hit hard. Nobody home.
Right in the face.
Johnny Grunge on the outside. Waiting to get that tang. And watch out now. Dusty Wolf in. And Nick Patrick is right on the double. Oh, right hand to the face again. And oh, and again to the midsection.
Hitting them with elbows. Let me do just keep hitting them.
Hard to the turnbuckle.
Rocco looks like he hit his rib. I tell you, the turnbuckles are a nasty place. Nothing but bolts and a lot of times wires stick out of there. Cut you to shreds, man.
Knee. Measured him for the right hand of the face. And Dusty Wolf. And look at this.
Well, yeah, I tell you, Grunge better quit jawing with Patrick there. He's pulling him out of position.
One only. Tony Carr wanted to make a save. There's a clothesline from Dusty Wolf. And an elbow drop. Here's a cover. One, two, got a two count.
Yeah, a little too nonchalant there. Rocco's big stick guy.
Head first.
Gotta stay him. Gotta keep him away from Grunge if these guys have a chance. Pull him back. He's hitting him too much. Gotta pull him back to his corner.
Nick Patrick wanting Dusty Wolf once again, but Dusty Wolf, relentless. Rocco Rock, his only move that time was a drop back to the mat. But yeah, that's a nice job by Dusty Wolf cutting him off, though.
Yeah, he cut him off. Again, that's the secret. Don't let Rocco make the tag. Get a man down, wear him down. But positioning isn't that great.
Mr. Clothesline. Mr. Back Elbow. And that time they collide. Johnny Grunge needs a tag. Watch out.
Got it.
Here he comes. Johnny Grunge. Clotheslines one. And clotheslines another. How about that?
Oh, it took too long.
You're not kidding. It took too long.
Getting a little greedy there was Grunge. And
Rock a rock. How about that double DDT by Grunge?
Now, Grunge was lucky. Rocco was in the right spot at the right time. Pulled him over. Said these guys worked well together.
Up. Down. It's over. Grunge, Johnny Grunge got in. It was all over, Larry.
Yeah, I tell you, they made a mistake with Rocco. Dusty Wolf had him, but didn't pull him back to his corner. And Rocco did what he had to do. He made it to his partner. Right there, and Rocco tagged Johnny Grunge, came in, made his move. Waited a little too long, but it worked out well because the Public Enemy works well together. Right here, pick two, pick the drop.
Your winners, Public Enemy, a worldwide wrestling. Coming up next, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Rey Mysterio, Junior Psychosis. Welcome back, fans, to Worldwide Wrestling. And we have two big matches to go, including Hacksaw Jim Duggan coming out in just a moment, and Rey Mysterio Jr. and Psychosis in our main event. This could be a classic case of USA against Cuba. Fidel Sierra will face Hacksaw Jim Duggan in this one-on-one matchup.
Fidel brought any cigars with him.
That's contraband. Can't do that.
Only contraband if you don't smoke them and they find them.
You mean if you smoke them, it's okay?
Well, it doesn't work.
Okay.
There's no evidence.
Well, I mean, well, forget it. Here we go.
Now, don't say Cuban cigars around Hacksaw. He'll break them on you.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
the red, white, and blue, and here he comes, a worldwide.
Kind of reminds me of the Wizard of Oz. If he only had a brain.
Oh, wait a minute, Larry. I know he's different. I know he stomps the feet. I know he's... But I know Hacksaw Jim Duggan personally. He's a very intelligent man. He's a great guy to be around. Truly one of my favorites.
Well, I know you like him. You know, it's hard not to like the guy because you always have sympathy for the simple. The thing is, I've known Hacksaw Duggan, you know, when he first started. And the thing that amazes me is... He knew exactly the same 20 years ago when he started. He hasn't gotten any better. If he wasn't as big and as strong as he is, he never would have made it this far.
Now let's define by getting any better. I mean,
he never increased his repertoire.
Well, he didn't need to. I mean, I don't think there's any denying that more times than not, and I would say 80%, 90% of the time, when Duggan comes out here, he wins. He's been a U.S. heavyweight champion. He's been financially successful. What more do you want? I mean, what were your goals here?
See, I'm a perfectionist, and to be a wrestler, your goal has to be the ultimate. You want to be the heavyweight champion of the world, and because he hasn't ever increased his repertoire and depended on just power, he was never the heavyweight champion of the world.
Now, there's also a little political factor here, and that is during the time that Hollywood Hogan held the world title, he wouldn't give Duggan a shot. Duggan made a claim that right here on this program. That
he wouldn't give a lot of people. I mean, Hogan is not a stupid man. That's why he never would get in the ring with me.
Well, Duggan's the type of guy, situation right, right circumstances, and going after the world title, getting the title shot, he could win it. Snapmare takeover. You know what they say?
The stranger things have happened.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of wrestlers will say this, a lot of promoters, that on any given day, any one of the stars, if they're hot, if things are working right, could win the world heavyweight title.
Well, I mean, I can't argue that, you know, there is that million to one shot. I've seen it happen. And I'm sure that's what Hogan thinks with the Goldberg story, a fluke, but the odds are against you.
Think about many years ago, around 20 years ago, Tommy Rich won the world heavyweight title from Harley Race and lost it the very next day.
Yeah.
Now, you know, that was
a fluke.
Well, yeah, I mean, but you still got to be a good wrestler to win the world title. But the fact is that it was a case of a young up-and-coming star and the great veteran, and it just happened to be right for him.
Yeah. Destiny will play a part in the outcome of your life.
Back elbow to the side of the head. And hit first. Duggan put the brakes on that.
Yeah, Duggan's just too strong to try to muscle around and push around. You've got to use the science. And Fidel here, he tried to push around the wrong man.
Well, those are heavy right hands. Any guy who's been in the ring with Hacksaw Jim Duggan will tell you that he is one of the hardest hitters in our sport.
You don't want to be looking at Hacksaw's face with him pounding on you.
In, up, down. All right. 3-point stance.
I think he's going to run him over if Fidel can get up.
He ran him over with a clothesline. And now, oh, glory. One, two, see ya!
I thought he was in a three-point stance, but he closed one of those, Fidel.
He really did.
Take the over.
Duggan secures yet another win.
And another victory.
Yes, that's what we're celebrating here. And truly, say what you want to about him. I know you have, living legend. You give Duggan a title shot, Duggan couldn't walk away the world title, of course. Goldberg is a champ right now. I don't think anybody can beat him, but in another situation, I think Duggan could become the world champion. Fans love him as well. We're going to take you back to the replay, I do believe. Oh, we're going to have a little bit more of this parade.
Sounds like a parade, doesn't it? One man parade, Hacksaw.
There it is.
All right, here, Phil made a mistake and just trying to out muscle Hacksaw. Aren't too many men alive that can come close to that. Right here, springing up. Just caught Sierra underneath the chin, and down he goes. A lot of weight dropping down on your face, brother.
The winner is Hacksaw Jim Duggan, 2x4 and all. Coming up next, Rey Mysterio Jr. against Psychosis. Right now, we'd like you to listen to this.
Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall here. You know, we hear the term dysfunctional family tossed around, well, probably too often than it should be. But in just a couple of seconds, I'm going to really introduce you to a person that exemplifies what a dysfunctional family member is all about. But I'll rather remind you first about the next big WCW pay-per-view. I'm talking about Fall Brawl. Yes, coming up September 13th this year. And this time we will be at the Lawrence Joel Coliseum in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. We invite you to come on into North Carolina. Or if that's just not convenient for you, you can still be a part of Fall Brawl, of course. Call your cable operator right now and see this one on pay-per-view. DirecTV with Direct Ticket. It's also available on the Dish Network. And satellite owners, we encourage you to call Turner Premier and be part of WCW and NWO Fall Brawl, Sunday, September 13th. We are going to come live from Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Now, I speak about the dysfunctional family, and I know how much family really means to the Guerrero family, perhaps one of the cornerstones of this sport. And, Chavo, I must say, I've noticed... Well, come on, then, you fill in the blanks here. You help me out here. I've noticed recently Eddie seems at least to, I don't want to say tolerate, but maybe he's a little bit more understanding of you.
Did you just say Eddie Guerrero?
Well, I did, Eddie Guerrero, yes, your uncle.
I've got one thing to say to you, Eddie Guerrero.
It's about time. Go ahead, let him have cameras right there.
I love you, man!
How can you say that?
Hey, I still love him. He's still my favorite wrestler. We'll always be together, Eddie. We're always going to be family. We fought before WCW. We're going to fight long after WCW.
I guess that's one way to look at it, but, I mean, he was telling tales about how your grandmother was walking the streets of El Paso with a paper bag over her head because she was ashamed of you.
Well, she cut her hair. She liked the way my hair cut. She cut it, but it cut too short. Got a little nick on her head, so that's why she had to wear the paper bag for a couple days. But it's looking good, Grandma. It's looking really good.
Thank you for the fashion tips, Chavo. I don't believe Grandma's walking around El Paso with a nicked head and a paper bag. Don't forget Fall Brawl coming up, fans. Jeez.
Hey, living legend, before we go back to the ring, here's a look at what's on tap next week on Worldwide Wrestling. Saturn will be with us in singles competition. Always a treat to see this tough guy in singles competition. He'll be with us here next week. And then from there we have...
Right here, big, big man, Roadblock, and he's going to try his best to squash somebody.
Over 300 pounds, Roadblock will be with us as well. Also, in tag team action, Viano 4 and 5, they're my tag team from south of the border. They'll join us in a tag team action next week. And, of course, we also have...
In the main event, Brian Adams trying to press the New World Order on Team Hollywood.
He'll be joined by Vincent as well. It's all next week on WCW Worldwide. And you never know on this program. Could happen. I know we've been really bucking for it. It could happen. They will get an appearance from the Nitro Girls to stop in and say hello.
Are they stopping by to say hi?
Yeah, they might. Do you have any connection that would get them here?
I may be able to get a few. You know, I do appearances with them on the road.
I know that recently our fans who watch our program in the Cincinnati, Ohio area saw that you and the Nitro Girls were at the Crown, where we had opening day ticket sales for an event coming up later this year. Have a good time.
They get your heart pumping, brother.
Have a good time.
I'll drink the fifth.
You'll plead the fifth.
I'll plead anything.
Yes.
Insanity.
Yes. You may know him as a living legend, but when it comes to the Nitro Girls...
Stop it.
Okay, Rey Mysterio Jr. And Psychosis to go one-on-one.
You can't help it. Look at just a sweet little thing.
They're gorgeous. Not only are they the most beautiful girls on cable TV, but they also are seven of the nicest young ladies I've ever met. I mean, they're
way too nice. Makes you want to shower them with charge cards and things.
Oh, boy. You're,
I can't believe I said that.
You're really whacked out. Yeah, I told you. All right, Rey Mysterio Jr. and Psychosis one-on-one in this matchup. Rey Mysterio Jr. battled back from reconstructive knee surgery.
Yeah, I tell you, it's not easy. Some of these guys come back way too soon from, surgeries, even if it's orthoscopic. Doctors tell you, you can walk in a couple months. You know, and walking is one thing, but competing... I'd say I'd give it a good year before I'd ever come back. I mean, you've got to be 100%. Otherwise, you'll break it again.
Also, I'll let you know, fans, that next week, in addition to all the great stars, all the great matches that we're going to have, we are also going to have an update what went down at Road Wild this past weekend from Sturgis, South Dakota, including Jay Leno's debut in the wrestling ring. That's all coming up next week on Worldwide Wrestling.
So if you relive the moments of Road Wild, you want to see what happened again, or if you happen to miss it, first of all, shame on you, but also we'll have recap of what went down each match next week on Worldwide.
Hey, nice little hold here. Look how he puts the pressure behind the neck, pushing the head forward into the chest. If Rey Mysterio wasn't as, you know, basically, small as he is, man with a big neck would be in trouble with a simple little hold like that. Rey's just small and flexible. I can squirm out of predicaments I couldn't see a snake getting out of.
Psychosis biting the man on the fingers, as you can see, and kind of surprised that he's not working on the knee early on. He's working on the arm and the hand.
Well, you know, that's not bad thinking, though, because Mysterio thought he would. He expected that. He'd expect Psychosis not to go for the knee. It's a game of chess.
Up and down. Wow, what force that was.
Oh, what a snap. And again, Ray gives away so much weight, even to these guys, that, you know, with no meat on your bones, you feel every pounding you get.
Sure, and it's easy, and I say that not for me, but for the wrestlers, all of them, easy to throw Ray around because of his lack of size. But what he lacks in size, he makes up in heart. One, two, got a two count.
He squirmed out of it again. I mean, it's easy to throw him around, hard to catch him. So Ray's got to use his movement, and if he doesn't, he's in trouble.
Psychosis, I mean, very methodically now, try to butterfly up, but Ray.
Well, we blocked it. He's grabbing, yeah, him, put his hand behind his knees, trying to hold on so Mysterio can't pick him up. Mysterio, I mean, Psychosis, him and a kid, he tried to break the hands there.
That was a good move by Ray Mysterio. He just actually blocked that attempt at either a power bomb or a pile driver, whatever it is. Whatever they pick up again here, once again. But he comes away with a great move. And then a running clothesline sent him down. It's a basic move, Larry. We've seen it so many times in this program. I mean, we even talk a lot of times as commentators. I know you as a wrestler that maybe they use the clothesline or the lariat too much. But most of them use it very effectively.
Yeah, a lot of them guys do. And it's almost an easy way out sometimes. You know, years ago, the lariat was basically illegal because it jarred your neck so much and guys were getting so many neck injuries. It was outlawed by state commissions. But since that's been lifted, you see a lot of guys using it. To me, it's a shortcut. But it's a very painful break your neck, rattle your brain shortcut.
We talk about Arn Anderson and his surgeries. I know that was from repeated clotheslines or pile drivers, anything that puts contusion on the neck and pressure on the vertebrae. Of course, it's a very vulnerable part of your body, and it amazes me that wrestlers don't have as many back injuries as they do. I mean, that obviously from the moves that we see, especially luchadors, the back, you would think, neck would be the first thing to go.
Yeah, well, backs are bad. Necks and knees are just the easy targets. Tell you, people don't realize what condition. These guys are in the greatest condition of all athletes in the world. And they go. Football players are good for 10 seconds, and they all get in a huddle. Basketball players, every time you touch them with a finger, they all get three shots, take a break, have a cigar. Wrestling, it just goes till you win.
What about golfers? I mean, they just...
Oh, golf. The best. The ball sits there and waits for you. You look good. Nitro girls carrying your bags. It's heaven.
You better watch yourself. You're going to give away a lot more than you need to on this program.
I already gave away a couple million. What's the difference?
Oh, are we having fun?
Yeah.
Yeah. Here's a look at Rey Mysterio blocking it now.
And Rey's a good blocker. He's a good technical wrestler. He just has to compensate for the size. There, he did it there. But again, not really big enough to take Psychosis high enough, fast enough to snap him over. That's why Psychosis was getting up.
Ray paid for that. A little bit too much time looking out, calling out to the fan.
Uh-oh.
And even Psychosis, oh my goodness, the guillotine leg drop. That could have broken his neck.
Yeah, just talking about necks. Well, that's one way.
And right now, Nick Patrick checking to see if there could be an injury here. I mean, that is so dangerous.
You know, I can't help thinking of Bagwell, because Bagwell broke his neck, was almost paralyzed. But
one, two, but he still kicks out. Can you believe that?
I just can't believe Bagwell makes such a light joke of that serious injury to turn it around on people. He even had me fooled. I thought he would see the light.
Well, let me tell you, let me give you a term that covers all, especially when it comes to Bagwell, and that is, once a meathead, always a meathead.
I wish I would have thought of that.
the way it is. You think an injury? You think seeing his career flash before his eyes was going to turn him around, make him a better guy? Not a chance. When you're a low life, you're going to stay a low life.
Hallelujah.
Duck the clothesline. A pick up, no. Now Rey Mysterio had the momentum and took him down with a head scissors takeover.
Yeah, that's one of his patented moves. I mean, he's great at that. Small guys can do those, but that's what Rey's got to keep doing. He's got to fancy Bantam and move and kick and run and pack and there you go.
Oh, wow.
It's Bantam in half.
That's what it did. I mean, the young man ran in, I mean, full throttle, dead sprint from the corner and ran right into the foot from Psychosis. Psychosis may be moments away from a big win here.
That's now or never, because boy, Mysterio took a heck of a shot.
Mysterio trying to fight off, and he does. He pushes the man off of the top turnbuckle.
That's a lucky break right there, the way Psychosis landed.
He's got him straddling the rope. My goodness, Uhura to run it.
Off of the rope.
One, two, he wins it.
He got him. Boy, you can never count little Ray out of there, I'll tell you that.
He turned a mistake by Psychosis into a win, and the fans, you know they're good looking, the fans love it here at Universal Studios Florida.
Who's that saying his armpit there?
I
couldn't read it.
I don't read armpits.
I don't read them either. It was just there.
First of all, here it is.
I tell you, Psychosis gave a hell of a shot. Mysterio finally used that movement. Hard man to pin and squirm out of predicaments right here.
Wow.
I thought Psychosis had him. Mysterio was kind of lucky. His neck slipped off that rope in time. Moves like this is what took Mysterio not only into popularity, but to many, many circles of victory. And Psychosis landing in the soft spot that do a victory here for Rey Mysterio. He's lucked out.
Ladies and gentlemen, next week, a complete rundown of what happened at Road Wild. The living legend Larry Zbysko and Stagger Lee Marsh by Tony Schiavone. See you next week on Worldwide Wrestling.
Welcome, everybody, to WCW Worldwide Wrestling. Tony Schiavone, along with the one, the only, living legend Larry Zbysko. We're going to begin things with Saturn in singles competition. And we've got quite a program, you know. I guess the theme of the program this week could be, in many ways, the flock. Saturn's coming out. Scotty Riggs going to wrestle a little bit later on. Member of the flock. And as we head to the 13th of September in Fall Brawl, Saturn has, as we're set to go in this first match, Saturn has made a statement. He's challenged Raven to another match coming up in Fall Brawl. And if he wins, the flock will be set free, Libby Legend. How about that?
Well, I tell you, the frenzy within the flock is flying because Saturn has disrupted all of the mind games set forth by Raven. It's going to be interesting because the flock, a group of mindless guys, you know, they need a leader. Raven's obviously a leader, but so is Saturn. Saturn is an individualist, and he could well take it over or whatever. I don't know, but bam, he nailed him.
Hit him with a running clothesline to the right side ropes. But missed an elbow drop. Mark LaRue is the opponent here. LaRue will send Saturn in. That was an attempt at a clothesline that he missed. And a pickup over the top. Dropped him on the back of the head.
Hey, Saturn, a tough guy. Good on the mat, too. I mean, he's a good submission wrestler and loves to fight. And he would be a handful.
Picked him up with a Death Valley driver. He's not going to waste any time here, Living Legend. Go do it right now.
Right in the back of the neck. LaRue should have taken the 23 skidoo. Too late.
This one's all over. Saturn looking around. I guess maybe he's looking for Raven to appear somewhere. But he's going to combine this Death Valley driver with the rings of Saturn.
A nice submission hold right there. Saturn's very good on the mat. Tough customer. Raven, maybe nevermore.
Saturn with ease. Up the top, WCW Worldwide with a win. And also this week, Jim Howard, Ryan Adams of the NWO, and much more.
Look at right there, right on the back of the neck. All the kids' weight coming down on it. And that just put this guy in la-la land. Like I said, LaRue should have skidooed because the rings of Saturn is a brutal, painful hold.
The winner is Saturn.
Coming up next, member of the NWO, but right now, here's Lee Marshall.
I want to make everybody in the tri-state area a heads up to Monday Nitro coming back to Nassau County Memorial Coliseum in beautiful Uniondale. Fans, the date is November 9th. November 9th. Tickets going on sale Thursday, August 27th. And you know what happened the last time we came into New York? We sold out the Nassau Coliseum. Don't get left out of this one. Get over to the Coliseum box office or any of the Ticketmaster outlets. It's not only going to be a great WCW NWO event, but it is Monday Nitro. Now, fans, be among the first to get your tickets by going to the box office on August 27th. In fact, why don't you drop by between 10:30 and 12:30? There you're going to meet some of the most beautiful women walking the face of the planet. You will get to meet the Nitro Girls. Oh, yeah, you'll also get to meet somebody else. He is the heavyweight champion of the world. He's Goldberg. He'll join the Nitro Girls for the first day of ticket sales. Goldberg, I'm not going to call you out here to sell tickets. That's not your job. I want to talk instead about what's going on with you and the Giant as it relates to Nitro. We've seen him choke slam you. We've seen you spear and jackhammer him. We're coming into New York. It doesn't get any bigger than that. With the world watching, Goldberg, something's got to give.
No, I want everybody to watch. I also want to touch on one point. Last time, Nitro, or whether it be Thunder, I didn't make it to Nassau Coliseum. And let me tell you, I will make up for it this next time. And I hope and I pray that I got the Giant in the ring with me. Because whether you saw me take the choke slam or you saw him take the tackle, you're going to want to see what's coming next.
I must tell you, there's a world of difference between the G-Man and the Man. And you will see them Monday, November 9th. Fans, get your tickets now. In fact, meet and greet Goldberg August 27th between 10:30 and 12:30. And the Nitro Girls, what a bonus that is.
We're back on Worldwide Wrestling, and still to come, fans, later on, the Disco Inferno in rigs in our feature bout. But coming up at Fall Brawl on Sunday, September 13th, already signed, Steiner Brother against Steiner Brother, living legend.
Well, you know something, Tony? I believe Scott Steiner's going to eat his words. I think he's going to regret ever turning against his brother. Rick Steiner, dog-faced gremlin that he is, still has his roots buried in tradition. And tradition always wins out.
Remember, this was the match we wanted to see, we thought we were going to see, at Road Wild, but it never took place. Fans, we're going to take you back to Sturgis, South Dakota, and show you all that went down back on the 8th of August. Right now, though, let's go to the ring. Our next bout, here's ring announcer Dave Benzer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Ashland, Kentucky, Bobby Blaze.
Bobby Blaze had a couple of big wins right on this program and our other programs on the WCW Network, but for Bobby Blaze, coming up right now, as you look at Blaze talking to referee Nick Patrick, I would venture to say one of his biggest tests, because he's got to face one of the biggest men of NWO Hollywood. That in mind, we take you back to ringing out to Dave Benzer. Here comes Brian Adams.
His opponent, representing the black and white of the New World Order, and accompanied to the ring by Vincent, from Kona, Hawaii, Brian Adams.
I tell you something, that's the key right there in the introduction. Brian Adams coming out, of course, with Vincent. Why don't these guys have the guts to come out and stand tall by themselves, Tony? I'll tell you the answer, they have no soul. They're gutless. And that means when it comes down to the wire, the bottom line, they won't win alone.
Well, maybe it comes down to this. You can be big and you can be strong, but there's a lot of big, strong guys who are cowards. And that's what they are, a group of cowards who cannot walk alone. Simply put, that's what it is.
I like to simply put it another way, but they bleep me. They live to bleep me.
You talking about the Texas gag order, that the famous...
No, Texas? Not Dusty Rhodes and his stupid threat. I'm talking about the producers.
The producers will get you. Okay, here we go.
Hey, Brian Adams, I mean, he's a confident guy, and he's a good athlete, big guy, but again, unless you walk out like a man, by yourself, without knowing, you know, in your mind, you've got someone out there watching your back, someone out there that's a distraction. Brian Adams will never be a bigger man as he looks.
Pretty big guy, though. Look at this.
He's got the power. He just don't have the soul.
Well, I agree with that. And Bobby Blaze, maybe not good strategy right here, Larry, to try to go in and hook up with a guy this size.
No, but nail him from behind. That's great.
In the midsection, Bobby Blaze, fist of fire.
Use that elbow.
What he's doing, not only using the elbow, but sledgehammer blows to that forearm. Bobby Blaze kicks him in the head for good measure. Oh, Brian Adams picked him up.
Oh, well, I hate to say it. That was pretty good. Brian Adams took a heck of a move.
Heck of a move.
Well, I want to say bad words.
Well, go ahead.
They'll bleep me.
Now, I know, but you can still say it. Here's a pickup. Boy, look at this.
He's got the power. Yeah, throw him at Vincent, the moron.
No, he goes with a gut buster from way up top from a gorilla press slam.
Wasting time, too. I'm surprised Brian Adams isn't trying to pin the man. He's got him flat.
Short leg drop by Adams. Let's do it again. No, he's going to stomp him this time in the chest. This has been all Brian Adams. From the opening bell, Bobby Blaze giving it a heck of a shot, but now in. Oh, Bobby Blaze caught him.
Boy, telegram, but it didn't have much of an effect. It just bounced off of Adams.
Got him up. Could be it. Oh, boy.
Well, this kid's in half.
That backbreaker. One, two. The end of the match. Brian Adams of the New World Order wins. Look at that face, would you? That's the face
of... I have to.
Yeah, unfortunately you do. It's part of your job. The face of a competitor, yes. The face of a member of the NWO and...
Scatman's brothers. There's a couple of mugs.
Oh, shut up.
I tell you, you can't deny the power of Brian Adams. I mean, he just handled Bobby Blaze like a baby. Stuffed him right there, almost broke the man in half. A couple fires in separate places, but it was the same guy burning. Brian Adams chalks up a victory. It's too bad.
When we come back, we'll take you back as promised to Road Wild and a whole lot more wrestling action on Worldwide. Stay with us.
What a night that was, Larry.
I'm telling you, the road is definitely a wild place. I've been on it for over 20 glorious years, but like you said, Tony, WCW, tradition prevails, and at the end, it always will.
Let me put a final note on this. We had talked many times leading up to the big match that Jay Leno was in the wrong spot, but Leno was very smart, and DDP and Leno had a game plan. Leno only came in at opportune times. He did what he could do, and then he got out. And Kevin Eubanks showed us a little bit. He had some pretty big guns on him. Yeah, looked pretty good.
Eubanks wasn't in bad shape. The Diamond Dallas Page, give him the credit. He protected Leno in a way. He only tagged him when he knew he could. Diamond Dallas played a perfect game of human chess.
Jim Powers coming on out now in the next bout here on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. Well, fans, the war that you saw a little bit of in that battle royal at Road Wild is just a sampling of the war that's been intensified throughout the weeks and months here between factions of the New World Order. Now we're heading to Fall Brawl. That means war games, two rings, the battle royal, the biggest, most dangerous event, two rings completely enclosed in a cage. And it hasn't been signed yet, but one would believe that you're going to see NWO go at it in there, Larry.
Well, that's what we want to see. That's what I'd like to see. Let them destroy each other. And, you know, I think if all these computer geniuses went back over their backs and find out more injuries occurred in war games than any other matches than any pay-per-views.
I would agree with that, and so would one Arn Anderson. Jim Powers and Mark Guthrie here. Anderson, of course, his career over, shortened by, and he would tell you as much as anything else, repeated injuries throughout the years in war games. Over the top.
I was in one war game. That was enough. I'm going to the golf course.
Arn Anderson was in the first one, the very first man to ever get in the ring. Into the rough. Powers, great hip toss. Out of the corner, Jim Powers, scoop slam. Put him down.
Hey, Powers, good athlete, great shape. Oh.
Blows lightning down with the near side ropes. He is in great shape. And Guthrie, not a bad move to get out that time.
Now, break the momentum whenever you can. I mean, you got 10 seconds to to use out there. Make it your friend. Use the ring. Use time. Rocky King, he's been around a while, though, the referee. He's not easy to outsmart old Rocky in there.
No, Rocky's a veteran of ring wars. Hard-working young man is Rocky King. Back to the corner. And warning Mark Guthrie to get out of there. Guthrie got Jim Powers caught in the corner here, and he's going to try his best. Better take the man down. It's much easier said than done, though. Powers, a lot of steam left in him. Sends him in. Into the gut he goes. Here comes his knee left.
Shades of Mr. Wrestling number two right there.
Certainly was a legendary one. A pickup. Jim Powers. Power slam. Jim Powers wins the power slam. When we come back, Roadblock still to come, but just on Bruno.
Hi, everybody. Staggerly, Lee Marshall sticking my nose into wrestling business because WCW and the New World Order returning to the Nassau Veterans Memorial Coliseum in beautiful Uniondale, Long Island. Last time we were there, it was a sellout. Fans, we don't want to see you turned away, and for that reason, when tickets go on sale throughout the tri-state, make sure you're among the first to get your tickets and join us for Monday night here in Uniondale. That's Monday, November 9th.
Our thanks to our good friends at Starburst Fruit Shoes as we're on the road. We're always on the road, it seems, but that's the way it is. Life in the pro wrestling circuit, Larry Zbysko.
Well, it's a different world from the normal everyday man. But I say if I had my life to do again, I wouldn't do it any other way.
And I'm sure wrestling fans would be glad to hear that. Roadblock, one of the biggest, most powerful, and they will say most feared man. He's a man that certainly knows how to use his weight to his advantage. Immediately sends Mike Sanders down. Look at this weight differential here. And Roadblock has come in like a house of fire.
Looks like he's wrestling a midget.
Tried to clothesline him, but Roadblock clotheslined him back.
The much bigger clothesline.
You're not kidding.
I say, when you get a man this size that can use his weight and has balance, yeah, I mean, tough to wrestle him, especially never go, you know, head to head. I mean, straight on. Guys, you've got to take them down off their feet. Of course, that's easier said than done. That was a 10 on the Richter.
Boy, you're not kidding. The whole Universal Studios Florida arena here, the worldwide arena, shook with Roadblock. Pretty good target, but I think the wrong approach here from Sanders. Ooh, missed an elbow. Now Sanders again, trying to go to that midsection, but nothing there.
That's a mistake. Big man in the corner like that, just back off and let him come to you. Make a move. Big men get tired fast. You've got to avoid them, you know, to stay away and make them miss stuff.
Missed the clothesline that time. He caught him in midair. The dead-end drop. Don't think he's going to get up from that. You mean he's got more?
Well, at least he won't be getting clotheslined again.
Well, you never know. Followed up with a big splash. Outside in. This one's up.
And a roly-poly splash.
Good turn. We'll use that next time. Determination.
You want the roadblock? You got him. Barking up the wrong rope.
But take a look at that. I mean, right there. Talk about using the weight under the chin. Roadblock, big man, has good balance. I said big men like that, it's just like trying to stop a bull when he sees red.
The winner is Roadblock. We come back, tag team action, plus Disco Inferno gets a member of the flock, and a whole lot more on Worldwide Wrestling. On Worldwide Wrestling. Now, two matches have been signed for Fall Brawl. Of course, as you see, Manny Fernandez and the very agile Doc Dean make their way out for this tag team match. We know the main event is the two-ring double cage war games. We'll be giving you information in the weeks to come on that, but we know it's going to be Rick Steiner against Scott Steiner one-on-one, like we talked about earlier, and it's going to be Raven against Saturn. Saturn wins. The flock is set free, and from the interviews we've been hearing, I don't think the flock really wants to be set free. They kind of like being under the tutelage, kind of the guidance of Ravens.
Yeah, well, they wouldn't know which way to fly. I mean, most birds would fly south. The flock, I think, would look more like a bunch of chickens with their heads cut off. They need a leader. So does this guy.
Well, he's bowing down to the Miata.
Of course he is.
Go figure that one out, huh?
They know something I don't know.
The masked men, Viano 4-5 against Manny Fernandez and Great Britain's Doc Dean.
Doc Dean's got a fetish about tassels.
He's an odd person, there's no question, and I don't think there's any denying. You ask any of the promoters, any of the tag teams in WCW, that the Vianos certainly are the best tag team out of Mexico and one of the best tag teams in the world, Larry.
Well, they've been wrestling together for a long time, too. That's going to make it tough on Doc Dean and Fernandez, who really haven't teamed up. I mean, Doc Dean's from England, and I don't even know where Fernandez is from.
Dean runs over. The other Viano gets a knee in the back, and Doc Dean nails him. Watch out. He gets close, lined down.
Good move.
So Dean goes back to the point of attack. Oh, Viano ran over him, raised a knee, caught him in the shoulder with it that time, Larry.
Yeah, you've been down too quick. That's the penalty. I mean, the Vianos are quick. All the luchadores are quick. It's that's their style. Oh, wow. Dean got him right there. To the tagged out.
And go to the power slam. Gets covered. Charles Robinson quickly to slide over and give it to. Charles Robinson, the fine referee. Here's a tag. He is on top of the action.
Blind as a bat.
He is not.
No, they all are.
They are not. Tag is made. The other Viano comes in, and Manny Fernandez, deep arm drag, kick down, puts him down again. Viano 5 is the man in, and Viano 5 goes down with another clothesline.
What else?
And Manny Fernandez is looking pretty good. As a matter of fact, Fernandez and Dean looking very sharp. Tag team!
Well, I tell you, he tried to pull him back to the right corner, trying to make a lot of tags, but he just stopped him cold.
Up and down.
Oh,
almost got him.
Thought he had him.
Viano 4. I'll make that. Is that Viano 5?
I don't know, but they did the right thing there. They tagged in, moved him over to his corner. What was that?
Looked like clothesline to me again. Down he goes. Grabbing the neck and the head, turning. Oh my goodness! A guillotine leg drop from the outside.
Yeah, what happens when you have good tag team work? They got right positioning, keeping Doc Dean far away from his partner.
Come on, ref, get him off the ropes! Come on, ref!
Double team here at Viano's. Great tag team strategy, positioning, DDT.
Hey, a nice execution of moves. Doc Dean, he's in trouble. He's got a tag, man.
Look at this pinning combination here. One, two.
I don't know if you're going to pin him, but you can make a wish.
Charles Robinson had to make sure that was not a chokehold. Knee was on the chest, not the throat. That was an unusual look that time from the Viano. Missed a clothesline. Back kick. Tag. Fernandez, clothesline. Wow. Clothesline City.
Well, this is their opportunity right now, and he took the leap of faith but missed.
And the Viano's up top. And why not? Across body. One, two, Viano's win.
And got him.
Viano 4, Viano 5. Once again, solidifying their rankings in the tag team wars.
Right there, I don't know what they're talking about, but that team could use a little Ben Gay. Viano just out tag team. The two guys who team a lot against two guys that really aren't partners. And you can see it was a big difference. Viano's just all over him, great ring positioning, a lot of tags.
winners be on those 4-5 with our Bengay replay brought to you by Extra Strength Bengay. It's the strongest Bengay ever. Coming up next, Disco Inferno, Scotty Riggs. Right now, we invite you to listen to this.
Hi, everybody. Stagger Lee Marshall sticking my nose in the wrestling business because WCW and the New World Order returning to the Nassau Veterans Memorial Coliseum in beautiful Uniondale, Long Island. Last time we were there, it was a sellout. Fans, we don't want to see you turned away, and for that reason, when tickets go on sale throughout the tri-state, make sure you're among the first to get your tickets and join us for Monday Night Raw in Uniondale. That's Monday, November 9th. Well, hi, everybody. Stagger Lee here, Lee Marshall, and I want all our fans in the tri-state area to just harken back a couple of months ago to when WCW was at Nassau Coliseum the last time. It was a total sellout, and fans, we are coming back, and I don't want you left out. For that reason, let me tell you, the WCW, the NWO, the Wolfpack is in the house November 9th. That is a Monday, and that means Nitro is coming to Uniondale. Fans, the best way for you to see this is, of course, live in the Coliseum. And at that point, you can start getting your tickets this Thursday. That's the first day of ticket sales. In fact, you can meet the World Heavyweight Champion. Goldberg will be there with the Nitro Girls at the Coliseum between 10:30 and 12:30. That's this Thursday when tickets first go on sale for WCW Monday Nitro, making our return to Nassau County and the beautiful Coliseum. Man, it was a total party the last time we were there. And for that reason, you talk about party, you got to be talking about Flyboy Rocco Rock, Johnny Grunz, Public Enemy in the house. And man, I can't help but think back to Disco Inferno at that pay-per-view. Flyboy, you put him through three tables. This man may never dance again.
I'm telling you, Lee, it was spectacular. It was amazing. It was stupendous. I'm telling you, but it was nothing like the last time I was in Nassau Coliseum. I walked that aisle. I was walking the walk and talking the talk when I stepped in the middle of the ring and I looked up. It wasn't an empty seat in the house.
Not a one he had.
So these people better get down there quick and get their tickets the minute they go on sale. Don't be a fool. Be cool. Go get them tickets fast.
Yep, that's going to be on Thursday, this Thursday, in fact, an opportunity to see Goldberg and the Nitro Girls and get the tickets for the hottest thing going Monday Nitro. It's November 9th at the Nassau County Memorial Coliseum in Uniondale. As Rocco said last time we were there, not an empty seat to be had. Snow Cone Guy even didn't have a seat.
Now let's take a look at next week's rundown on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. Second generation star Scott Putski will make his debut on Worldwide Wrestling next week.
Along with a man who will make you cry, Uncle Eddie, especially if you're his nephew.
Eddie Guerrero next week. Plus, well, we talked about him a lot. He'll be out here next week. Raven in singles competition in 1 week's time on Worldwide.
Along with the man of mystery who is extremely talented, Rey Mysterio Jr.
All plus a lot more next week on Worldwide Wrestling. Speaking of Raven, speaking of the flock, Riggs coming out. Former World Tag Team Champ. Another lost soul.
I tell you, this guy went downhill quick. I mean, came into professional wrestling with one idea and one goal, and finally, maybe through frustration or whatever, found out it's not near as easy as it looks. Many knock on the door of professional wrestling, but only one or two walk through it, brother. They survive.
Ready to dance?
No, I'd much rather watch ACJ.
Oh, you would you?
Wouldn't you?
Wait, there's a lot of things I'd rather...
You're a Whisper fan.
I'm not going to respond to that, but there's a lot of things I'd rather watch than this Schmo dance.
See what I mean? I think he's trying to grow a goatee, he just doesn't have enough hair. Where's Richard Simmons when you need him?
Let him dance. Nothing more I can say about this.
I'll just close my eyes and pretend it's somebody else. Is he done yet?
No, he's not.
Super.
Well, the young ladies here are not that thrilled about me just going for it, but
at least they're not blind.
Until he gets a few more beatings, I think he's going to learn the hard way, this kid.
Still living in the late 70s, early 80s is what he's doing. The Disco Inferno. And Ridge, two different sides of the spectrum here. One of our feature bouts here on Worldwide Wrestling. Ridge, of course, after September 13th, may no longer have to be a flock member.
Of course, with Ridge, if you could thumb him in that one eye, he couldn't see at all. I mean, just what I would do. Always go after a physical weakness.
A great plan, I think anybody thought of it. Ridge with a tremendous dropkick.
They'll think of it now.
Yeah, now that they've heard it from the mouth of the legend itself.
Not that I'm a nasty guy, but that would be my game plan with Ridge, thumb him in the eyes blind. Easy picking.
You're a nasty guy.
Back job. I'm a player of human chess.
Which means you got to be nasty to do it. Boom. And a great one by Disco Inferno. Deep on Drake kick.
Inferno's got the movement right here. If he can keep Riggs off balance, but Riggs knows better. I mean, he's thinking he's off balance. He escaped. Instead of going out after him, he's dancing again with some hypnotic pants. Remember the old hypnotic coin? Yeah, back of the magazine?
Yes, I
try to hypnotize your brother or something.
Back in the back of the comic book?
Never worked.
You got one, huh?
I bet.
Okay.
I hypnotized myself.
You were hypnotized when you opened the comic book up. Uppercut. From Riggs.
Yeah, I tell you, Riggs, no slouch in there. That's the only weakness. That's obvious is the one remaining eye. So that means always attack from Riggs' right. That's where his peripheral vision is blocked. Every little thing you can use against your opponent is helpful.
Let's go further with an attempt at a full-arm dragon twist. Gets nailed by Riggs, and he comes away with a suplex. Boy, you know, same old story. We've said it so many times. You've heard us say it in this Inferno match. You can see when he's focused, when he's homing in on his opponent, 1-2 count, that the man can really wrestle.
Yeah, he's got the qualifications. I think maybe just a little maturity is all the Disco needs. Problem is, if you're not focused, you won't survive to become mature enough.
I bet you if WCW officials told Disco Inferno, okay, dancing is illegal. Oh boy, up to the top rope. If you go out and you dance, even before the match starts, you get disqualified. You can't dance. I bet you if he had to resort just to wrestling, he would improve and he would get better and he would be a top-notch pro wrestler.
Oh, he may after a couple more shots like that. Oh, he squirmed out.
I mean, here's a guy who would rather dance and still became the world television champion. Into the rope, Disco ducked the clothesline. He missed the clothesline of his own, and both men collide.
That smack in midair, that knocked the wind out of both of them. I think Ridge is a little heavier, might have taken less toll on him.
Missed the clothesline there. Atomic drop.
Well, Riggs will be riding that porcelain pony. He got him!
With another clothesline. Cover. Two count.
I thought I heard three.
That was only two that time. Back elbow. Yeah. It's got further. Runs into a power slam. One, two. No, couldn't keep him down.
Yeah, Riggs was waiting for him. He was eyeing him up with that one good eyeball. And nice power slam, too, and gives the Disco credit. He squirmed out of saw it been coming.
Held on. Picks him up.
Oh!
Big power slam. He can win the match. One. And he does.
He did. See, now you can dance, kid. It's over.
Right.
Exactly hit me over.
All the replay.
Well, right here, Riggs got him. Riggs, good to before he gets defeated. Then after the bell rings, dance on, kid.
With the 1-2-3, your winner is the Disco Inferno. Vince, next week, more information about Foam Raw coming up Sunday, September 13th. And bring that to the living legendary Domestic Upper Shaggy Marshall. I'm Tony Giovanni. We'll see you next week on Worldwide Wrestling. Yeah, 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 yeah. You are.